אז הלילה זה ל"ג בעומר. למי שלא שמע, קרה משהו במירון, כמה אנשים מתו כי נדרסו, היה הרבה אנשים שם. אז אם רוצים, רק לקחת שנייה, ממש לכוון על לשלוח רפואה וממש עזרה לכל מי ששם, לכל מי שצריך את זה, עם האנרגיה של רבי שמעון. אוקיי. אז יש פסוק בגמרא שהולך ככה. הקדוש ברוך הוא גוזר והצדיק מבטלה. אז הקדוש ברוך הוא גוזר גזרות והצדיק, והצדיק מבטל את הגזרות. יכולתו של רבי שמעון גם הייתה לבטל גזרות, כלומר שינוי תהליכים בעולם הרוחני האמורים להביא תוצאות הרסוניות. אז בעצם כל פעם שהיה צריך להיות איזה דין בעולם, משהו צריך להיות נהרס או משהו, רבי שמעון אמר לא, זה לא יקרה בזמן שלי. וכך כתוב בספר הזוהר, יום אחד יצא רבי שמעון. שלום. יום אחד יצא רבי שמעון וראה העולם שהוא חושך ואפל ונסתם אורו. אמר לו רב... שלום. כן. אמר לו רבי אלעזר בנו, בוא ונראה מה רוצה הקדוש ברוך הוא. אז הם ראו חושך, אפל, הכל עננים שחורים, לא אפורים, שחורים. אז הוא אמר לבנו, בוא נראה מה הקדוש ברוך הוא רוצה עם כל האפל הזה. הלכו ומצאו מלאך אחד שהיה דומה להר גדול, יש מלאך בגודל ההר שמה, עומד שמה, והוציא 30 להבות אש מפיו, פתח את פיו, ו-30 להבות אש יוצאות. קצת מפחיד. אמר לו רבי שמעון, מה אתה רוצה לעשות? אז רבי שמעון שאל את המלאך, למה הוא שמה? אמר לו, אני רוצה להרחיב העולם, משום שלא נמצאים 30 צדיקים בדור. אז המלאך אמר, הקדוש ברוך הוא שלח אותי, כי אין 30 צדיקים פה בדור שלכם, אז צריך להרחיב את העולם. למה? כי כך גזר הקדוש ברוך הוא על אברהם, ואברהם היה יהיה. אז יש סיפור מהתנ״ך שהקדוש ברוך הוא שלח מלאכים לסדום, להרוס את סדום, ואברהם ביקש להציל אותם, אם יש 50 צדיקים תציל אותם, הקדוש ברוך הוא אמר אין 50, אם 40, הקדוש ברוך הוא אמר אין 40, אם 30, אין 30. אז המילה שאברהם משתמש בו זה יהיה, והמילה יהיה בגמטריה זה 30. אז בגלל זה, כי אין 30, אז זה צריך להרחיב את העולם. אמר לו רבי שמעון, אז רבי שמעון ענה למלאך, בבקשה ממך, לך לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא ואמור לו, בן יוחאי נמצא בעולם. אז הוא אומר למלאך, לך תגיד לקדוש ברוך הוא שאני נמצא פה, דהיינו רבי שמעון, שזכותו גדולה כמו 30 צדיקים, והזכות שלי זה כמו 30 צדיקים וזה מספיק, אז לא צריך להרחיב את העולם. הלך המלאך ההוא לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא, ואמר לו, ריבון העולם, גלו לפניך מה שאמר לי בן יוחאי. אז המלאך מדבר עם הקדוש ברוך הוא, אמר, תראה מי פגשתי את רבי שמעון בר יוחאי, ואתה בטח, אתה הקדוש ברוך הוא, אתה בטח יודע מה הוא אמר אליי. אמר לו הקדוש ברוך הוא, לך אחרי את העולם, ואל תבט על בן יוחאי. אז הקדוש ברוך הוא ענה, לך תעשה את זה, לך תרחיב את העולם. ואל תפנה אל רבי שמעון. כשבא, ראה רבי שמעון את המלאך, אמר לו, אם לא תלך לקדוש ברוך הוא, בשליחותי אגזור עליך שלא תיכנס לשמיים. אז רבי שמעון עכשיו מאיים על המלאך, הוא אומר, אם אתה לא חוזר לקדוש ברוך הוא שאני אומר לך, אז אני לא אתן לך להיכנס חזרה לשמיים. ותהיה במקום יש שמות פה שאסור להגיד, אבל זה מקום מאוד, זה כמו גיהנום, שהפיל אותם השם משמיים לארץ. אז יש שני מלאכים שנפלו מהשמיים לארץ. וכשתבוא לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא תאמר לו, אז הוא עוד פעם אומר למלאך הזה, לך תגיד לקדוש ברוך הוא, אם אין 30 צדיקים בעולם, יהיו 20, כי כך כתוב. אז הקדוש ברוך הוא אמר, אז הקדוש ברוך הוא אמר לאברהם, בזמן של אברהם, הם הלכו, הם מעבר ל-30, אם אין 30, אז אין 30, אם אין 20, אז אין 20, אז אם אין 10, אז הם הלכו מדרגה מדרגה.
בבא, יושב לו את הברוד, מה יהיה אחר כך?
אז רבי שמעון בר יוחאי אומר למלאך, בדיוק כמו שהקדוש ברוך הוא עשה עם אברהם, תעשה איתי. אם אין 30 יש 20, אם אין 20 יש 10, ואם אין 10 יוש שניים, שהם אני ובני. אז עכשיו רבי שמעון אומר שאפילו אם אין 10 צדיקים, אני ובני זה מספיק להציל את העולם. כי כך כתוב, על פי שניים עדים יקום דבר. כי יש פסוק בתורה שאומר, על פי שניים עדים יקום דבר, אז יקום, אז יקיים העולם על פי שני אנשים, על פי רבי שמעון בר יוחאי ורבי אלעזר. ואין דבר אלא העולם שכתוב, בדבר השם שמיים נעשו. ואם אין שניים, הרי יש אחד, ואני הוא. ואם אתה אפילו לא מסתכל על רבי אלעזר כמו צדיק, אני בטוח צדיק, רבי שמעון אומר. שכתוב, וצדיק יסוד העולם. וצדיק הוא היסוד של העולם, אז אם יש רק אחד, זה אני מספיק בשביל להציל את העולם.
בואי.
נא להישאר על מיוט. בא בשעה, יצא קול בשמיים, ואמר, אשרי חלקך רבי שמעון. אז מיד אחרי שהוא אמר את זה, הקול של הקדוש ברוך הוא יצא מהשמיים, הוא אמר, אשרי חלקך רבי שמעון. הקדוש ברוך הוא גוזר למעלה, ואתה מבטא למטה. עליו כתיב, רצון יראיו יעשה. אז זה סיפור אחד על איך אפילו אם הקדוש ברוך הוא רוצה להחריב את העולם, רבי שמעון בר יוחאי היה כל כך קדוש, היה כל כך גבוה, שהוא היה יכול לעצור את זה בלבד. יש עוד סיפור שאני רוצה לספר, על רבי שמעון שהוא מבטל אפילו גזירת מוות על מישהו. רבי יצחק היה יושב יום אחד בפתחו של רבי יהודה, היה עצוב. אז רבי יצחק יושב בבית של רבי יהודה, והוא שם עצוב. יצא רבי יהודה, הוא מצא בפתחו, אז רבי יהודה קם בבוקר, יצא לעבודה, ופתאום יש פה רבי יצחק, יושב לו שם. הוא אומר, מה אתה עושה פה? אמר לו רבי יצחק, באתי אליך לבקש ממך שלושה דברים. אז רבי יצחק אמר, יש לי שלושה דברים שאני רוצה ממך. אחד, כאשר תאמר דברי תורה ותזכיר מאלו הדברים שאמרתי אני, אז בעתיד שאתה אומר דברי תורה, ושאתה אומר דברי תורה שאני אמרתי, תאמר אותם בשמי. תגיד את שמי ליד הדבר תורה הזה, כדי להזכיר את שמי. ואחד, שתזכה את בני יוסף בתורה, אז הוא רצה שרבי יהודה ילמד את בנו יוסף התורה. ואחד, שתלך לקברי כל שבע ימים של אבלות, ותתפלל תפילתך עליי. ואחרי שאני אמות, בכל שבע ימים של אבלות, אני רוצה שתלך לקברי ולהתפלל עליי. אמר לו, מאין תדע שתמות? אז רבי יהודה אמר, רגע, איך אתה יודע שאתה מת עכשיו? אמר לו רבי יצחק, הנה נשמתי מסתלקת ממני בכל לילה, ואין המאירה לי בחלום כמו מתחילה. אז כשרבי יצחק היה הולך לישון, הנשמה עולה לגן עדן, והוא היה רואה אותה בחלום, מה היא עשתה בגן עדן, ועכשיו החלומות הוא לא רואה כל כך ברור. אז בשבילו זה אמר שהנשמה קצת מנותקת. ועוד כשאני מתפלל ומגיע לשומע תפילה, יש ברכה בתפילה לשומע תפילה, אני מסתכל בצלם שלי, וזה לא צלם פיזי, זה צלם מוכני, שעל הכותל, ואיני רואה אותו. אז יש לכל בן אדם צלם רוחני, ומי שעל מדרגה, על מדרגה, על מדרגה גבוהה, כמו רבי יצחק, כמו רבי שמעון, הם היו יכולים לראות את זה. והוא לא ראה את הצלם הרוחני שלו. הוא אומר אני, שעמות, הואיל שעבר ממני הצלם ואיני נראה, כי כרוז יוצא ומכריז שכתוב, אך בצלם יתהלך איש. אז יש פסוק שאומר שבלי צלם אין, בלי צלם אין בן אדם, אז הצלם הזה הרוחני, זה איך יודעים אם הבן אדם יחיה או ימות. אמר לו רבי יהודה, כל אלו הדברים שביקשתם ממני אעשה. אז רבי יהודה עונה, אני אעשה מה שביקשתם ממני, אבל אני מבקש ממך שבעולם ההוא תבחור מקומי אצלך כמו שהייתי אצלך בעולם הזה. כשאתה מגיע לגן עדן, תשמור לי מקום לידך. אני רוצה להיות לידך אפילו בגן עדן. ואחר רבי יצחק ואמר בבקשה ממך שלא תפרוד ממני כל אלו הימים. ורבי יצחק בכה ואמר, אני לא רוצה שתעזוב אותי כל אלו הימים עד שאני אמות. הלכו אל רבי שמעון. מצאו שהיה עוסק בתורה. כשהם הגיעו לרבי שמעון, רבי שמעון היה עוסק בתורה. נשא עיניו רבי שמעון וראה את רבי יצחק. אז רבי שמעון ראה את רבי יצחק וראה שמלאך המוות רץ לפניו ורוקד לפניו. אז רבי שמעון היה, הוא היה יכול לראות את מלאך המוות, והוא ראה אותו כאילו רוקד לפני רבי יצחק. קם רבי שמעון ואחז בידו של רבי יצחק, רבי שמעון קם ולקח את היד של רבי יצחק ואמר, גוזר אני, מי שרגיל לבוא אצלי יבוא, ומי שלא רגיל לבוא אליי לא יבוא. אז הוא אמר, רבי שמעון אמר, יש גזרה עכשיו, מי שרגיל לבוא לבית שלי, כאילו רבי יצחק ורבי יהודה, יבוא, ומי שלא רגיל לזה, כאילו מלאך המוות, לא יבוא. אז הוא בעצם אמר למלאך המוות, אסור לך לבוא לביתי. נכנסו רבי יצחק ורבי יהודה, קשר בזה את מלאך המוות לחוץ, ולא יכול להיכנס. אז עכשיו, בגלל הגודל של רבי שמעון, אפילו מלאך המוות לא יכול להיכנס, כי הוא אמר לו, לא להיכנס. הסתכל רבי שמעון וראה, שעד עתה, עוד לא הגיע זמנו למות, אלא עד שמונה שעות של היום, אחוז זמנו. אז רבי שמעון ראה ברבי יצחק שזה עוד לא השעה שלו למות, יש לו עוד כמה שעות לחיות. הושיבו לפני רבי שמעון ועסק עמו בתורה. אמר רבי שמעון ברבי אלעזר בנו, שב בפתח ומי שתראה לא תדבר עמו, ואם נרצה להיכנס כאן, תשווה שבועה שלא ייכנס. אז הוא לקח את רבי יצחק והתחיל ללמוד תורה איתו, והוא אמר לבן שלו רבי אלעזר, שב בחוץ, ואף אחד, אל אפילו תדבר איתו, ואף אחד לא ייכנס. סליחה?
לא, אני אמצאת על הסקט. למה לא מדבר?
אמר רבי שמעון לרבי יצחק, הראית צורת אביך ביום הזה או לא? אז רבי שמעון התחיל לשאול אותו שאלות. האם חשבת שראית את האבא שלך היום? כי למדנו בשעה שאדם מסתלק מן העולם, אביו וקרוביו נמצאים שם עמו, ורואה אותם ומכירים. אז אפילו אם הם כבר נפטרו, לפני שבן אדם מת, הוא רואה כל מי שהיה קרוב אליו. וכל אלו שיהיה משכנו עמהם, בעולם ההוא במדרגה אחת. וכל מי שבאותו מדרגה של, באותו מדרגה רוחנית שלו, הוא גם רואה אותם לפני שהוא מת. כולם מתקבצים ונמצאים עמו, והולכים עם נשמתו. עד המקום שישכן שם. אמר רבי יצחק, עד אתה עוד לא ראיתי את צורת אבי. אז רבי יצחק אמר, לא ראיתי את זה. בתוך זה קם רבי שמעון ואמר, ריבונו של עולם, נודע רבי יצחק אצלנו, ומאלו שבע עניינים הוא כאן, דהיינו משיבת התלמידים שנשארו בחיים ביציאתם מאידרא רבה קדישא. אז רבי שמעון התחיל לדבר עם הקדוש ברוך הוא, אמר, יש לנו פה רבי יצחק, הוא אחד מהתלמידים שלי הכי גבוהים, הוא אחד מהשבע שיצאו איתי מהאידרא רבה, שנדבר על זה אחר כך. הנה אני אוחז בו ותן אותו לי. אני לוקח אותו ואתה לא, ואתה תיתן אותו לי. אז בעצם רבי שמעון אומר לקדוש ברוך הוא, לא תיקח אותו ממני, הוא נשאר פה. יצא קול ואמר, הנה שלך רבי יצחק, ותבוא עמו בזמן שתבוא לשבת בכיסאיך. אז הקדוש ברוך הוא ענה לרבי שמעון, הוא אמר, בסדר, אתה לוקח את רבי יצחק, וכשאתה תבוא אליי, כאילו שרבי שמעון נפטר, הוא לקח את רבי יצחק איתו. היינו בשעה שיפטור רבי שמעון מן העולם, אמר רבי שמעון, ודאי, כלומר, כן אעשה שאביהו עמי בשעת פטירתי מהעולם. בתוך כך ראה רבי אלעזר שמלאך המוות נסתלק, ואמר, אין גזר דין קיים במקום של רבי שמעון. אז רבי אלעזר ראה, הוא היה יושב בפתח הבית, והוא ראה שפתאום מלאך המוות נסתלק. אז הוא אמר, וואי וואי וואי, רבי שמעון אומר משהו, והגזרה בטלה ככה. אמר רבי שמעון לרבי אלעזר בן עום, בוא הנה, ואחוז בו ברבי יצחק, כי אני רואה אותו שהוא מפחד. נכנס רבי אלעזר ואחז בו, ורבי שמעון החזיר פניו ועסק בתורה. ישן רבי יצחק וראה את אביו. אז רבי יצחק הלך לישון והוא ראה את אביו, אמר לו אביו, בני אשרי חלקך בעולם הזה ובעולם הבא. אז בחלום הוא ראה את האבא שלו, ואבא שלו אומר לו, אשרי חלקך. כי בן העלים של עץ החיים מגן עדן אתה יושב, אילן גדול וחזק בשני העולמות הוא רבי שמעון, אשר הוא אוחז אותך בענפיו, אשרי חלקך בני. אז אבא שלו אומר, כמה טוב לך שרבי שמעון לקח אותך, כי האילן הגדול, זה, יש שם לרבי שמעון, זה כמו האילן הגדול, כמו עץ החיים, כי הוא היה כל כך גדול בתורה, הוא היה כמו עץ החיים גם פה בעולם הזה וגם בעולם הבא. אמר לו, אבי, ומה אני שם בעולם האמת? אמר לו, שלושה ימים היו מכינים בחיפזון את חדר משכבך, ותקנו לך חלונות פתוחים להעיר לך מארבע רוחות העולם, ואני ראיתי מקומך ושמחתי שאמרתי אשר חלקך בני. לבד שעד אתה לא זכה בנך בתורה, שהייתי מצטער מזה. אז רבי יצחק רצה לדעת, אוקיי, זה רבי שמעון, זה החלק של רבי שמעון בעולם הבא, מה עם החלק שלי? אז אבא שלו אומר, אל תדאג, החלק שלך מצוין בעולם הבא, אבל אני דואג על הבן שלך כי הוא עוד לא עסק בתורה. והרי אתה, היו עתידים לבוא אליך י' ב' צדיקים מן החברים, ובעוד שהיו יוצאים, נתעורר קול בכל העולמות. מי הם החברים העומדים כאן? התעטרו בשביל רבי שמעון, שביקש בקשה מהקדוש ברוך הוא, דהינו שלא ימות רבי יצחק וניתנה לו. אז בעצם הלילה הזה, זה של ל"ג בעומר, הכוח של רבי שמעון בר יוחאי זה לבטל גזרות, לבטל מוות, זה דברים שאנחנו לא חושבים שהם יקרו אי פעם, הלילה הם יקרו. למה? כי רבי שמעון רוצה ככה. אז אם ממש מתחברים לאנרגיה של רבי שמעון ולומדים זוהר היום, קצת אחרי עבודה או לפני עבודה, אז ממש להתחבר לאנרגיה של רבי שמעון הלילה ומחר. תודה רבה. אם יש שאלות אני יכול לענות.
Hi everyone, ל"ג בעומר שמח. So I'm going to be starting with a story, but before I do that, I just want to take a moment. So I don't know if you guys heard, but in Meron, a few hours ago, there was a lot of people that were injured. So if we could all just make sure to think about all these people that were injured and hope they get speedy recovery. And through this learning, we can help them. Okay, so the story that I'm going to tell, it happened in 1923. And it was when Lag BaOmer, what we're celebrating tonight, it fell on a Friday. So there was thousands and thousands of people in Israel going to visit the grave of Rabbi Shimon. And it happened to be that there was a mom and her child, it was time to cut his hair because he turned three. And there's a tradition that when a boy turns three, we cut his hair. So they have his hair cut, but he unfortunately passes away. And the mom takes the kid and she goes to the grave of Rabbi Shimon and she throws the kid on the floor and she tells Rabbi Shimon, you know, I prayed for you for a kid and I finally have one and he's my only son. And now he passed away. He's dead. I said I would bring him when it's his third birthday and I brought him. So what am I supposed to do now? You have to help me. She's sobbing and sobbing and sobbing. And eventually she leaves, but the kid is still there. So she's sobbing and sobbing. And so the kid wakes up and he says, mom, I'm thirsty. So they call the mother back and the mother comes and she says, thank you, Rabbi Shimon. Thank you for saving my kid. So I think what I got from this story is that sometimes all we really need to do is ask, because instead of just giving up and saying, okay, no one can help me anymore, I can't do anything, we should make the effort to ask. Okay, now I'm going to go to Izol of Hazinu in part 48 and verse 196. So this talks about the passing of Rabbi Shimon. So it starts off, Amal Rabbi Abba. Rabbi Abba said, so Rabbi Abba was the scribe of the Zohar. So he wrote everything that the Rabbi Shimon and all the other rabbis taught. He wrote it down. Amal Rabbi Abba. Rabbi Abba said, Lo siyem butzina kadisha lememal chayim. The holy luminary, or Rabbi Shimon, barely finished uttering life. So what does that mean, barely finished uttering life? So in the past section, Rabbi Shimon was teaching something, and he was about to say a verse, and it said, Ki sham tziva Hashem et habachat chayim ad olam. So in Hebrew, chayim means life. So he wasn't able to finish the verse. That's what Rabbi Abba is saying. Ad ishtachachu milui. So when his word ceased, that's the last word that he said. Ve'ana katvana, I was writing, svalna lemichtav tepi, and was about to write more. Ve'lo shamana, and I did not hear. Ve'lo zikifna l'isha, and I did not raise my head. Dinora havasagi, because the light was so great. Ve'la hava yichana l'isaka, and I wasn't able to look at it. So Rabbi Abba is the one, the scribe, so he's looking down and he's writing, and he recognizes that there's this great light in the room, but he can't look up because it's such a bright light. Hidachi izdazana. I then trembled. I became like scared. Shemana kala de kare. And I heard a voice calling and saying, Vamal, elach yamim ushnot chaim v'gomel. And the voice said, for length of days and long life, which is a quote from Mishle. Shamana kalacha, and then I heard another voice, Chaim shal mimcha vigo. He asked the life of you. So what it's saying is that it's kind of saying to Rabbi Abba that now this is Rabbi Shimon leaving this world. And then it goes on to explain what happened that day. Kolahu yuma, all that day, lof sik esham min beita. The fire did not cease from the house. So there was a fire in the house, like a very bright fire, and it didn't stop. And no one reached for him, so Rabbi Shimon. Because they couldn't go to him because of the fire that was around him. And him meaning Rabbi Shimon. All day, Nifila al-ra. I was like bowing down on the ground, and I, meaning Rabbi Abba, so he was vigena, and I was crying loudly. So he was mourning Rabbi Shimon. Batal dazil esha, after the fire was gone, chamana libutzinat kadisha kodesh hakadashim, I saw that the holy luminary, the holy of holies, or Rabbi Shimon, the istalak mina alma, was gone from this world. Itatav shachiv alimena, I was wrapped around and lying on his right side, van poi chayichine, with a smiling face. So then it talks about Rabbi Shimon's son, Rabbi Elazar. Kam Rabbi Elazar bilya, Rabbi Elazar, Rabbi Shimon's son, got up. Venatil yodov v'neshaklon, took his hands and kissed them. So his again means Rabbi Shimon. So his son came and took Rabbi Shimon's hands and kissed them. And while I kissed the dirt under his feet. So I is Rabbi Abba. The friends started crying. So the friends are all the rabbis that are surrounding Rabbi Shimon, Rabbi Elazar, Rabbi Abba, around them. Rabbi Elazar Beliana fil talat zimnin. Rabbi Elazar then fell to the ground. And he couldn't open his mouth. He then opened and said, Abba, Abba, Father, Father. Talat havo chad achzelu. So there were three that became one again. And what does that mean, three that became one again? There were three great men in the land. Rabbi Elazar, so the son of Rabbi Shimon, that's the second one, and his father-in-law, Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair. Now, Rabbi Elazar is alone. Rabbi Shimon just passed away, and he doesn't have his father-in-law. So after this, Rabbi Shimon passed away, it says that Hashtad Tanud Teveta. Now the beasts will wander, Tipalan Tasin, and the birds will sink, Mishtakan Binukvad Diamal Rabba, into the great sea, Vichavaya Kulu Shtain Dama, and it will drink blood. So what it's saying basically is that after Rabbi Shimon passed away, this great, great light in the world, a lot of things are going to be darkness. Kama Bichay. Rabbi Chia rose to his feet and said, "Ad hashta butzina kadisha mistakal alan." So up until now, Rabbi Shimon was taking care of us, was taking care of all these great rabbis. Hashta lav hu idan. Now it's our turn to honor him. Eladi ishada bekilia. So now they're going to honor him by taking care of his body. Kama bi alazal ve'rababa. Rabbi Elazar and Rabbi Abba rose and natlu lebi tika disika. They took his like what he was laying on his bed, and they made it like a ladder to. So they took him from where he was sitting, and they made it a ladder to put him up onto a bed. Man chama al buvia de chavaya. And it says that who has ever seen such confusion of the friends? Why? Because the whole house then emitted good fragrances. The whole house started smelling good. And the only people that served him, so the only people that took care of Rabbi Shimon after he passed away was Rabbi Elazar and Rabbi Abba. Atu tlikin umalait lisin. So the English translation says bullies and armed people. Dechapel tzipri v'tel dabu b'nei meronia. So these people came from the village of Tzipri, and they came to Meron. So why were they coming from Tzipri? Why were they coming to Meron? So it says that they wanted Rabbi Shimon to be buried in their city. Because, I mean, Rabbi Shimon was this great, great person, and everyone wanted that, to have the privilege of having his kevel, his grave, in their city. Batal dinafak pulia. So the people of Meron shouted at them and drove them away. Hava salik be avira, because they didn't want them there. But then after this whole discussion, argument that these people were having, the bed rose in the air. So the bed that Rabbi Shimon was laying on, it rose in the air. Vesha hava lehit kemea, and fire burned before it. Shemu kala, and then a voice was heard. Ulu vatu v'it kanshu lihulula de Rabbi Shimon. come and gather to the feast of Rabbi Shimon. Yavo shalom yenucho al mishkovotam. You shall enter in peace to them that rest in their graves. And then it goes on to say, kad alim le malata shemu kala bemalata. And then once the bed landed in the cave, they heard a voice inside the cave. This is the man who caused the earth to tremble and who provoked kingdoms. Kama pitlin bilkiyam mishtachachin boyoma din begincha. How many persecutors in the firmament are quieted today for your sake? Dinal Rashbi. This is Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Dimalei mishtabach be bechol yoma. With whom his master glorifies himself daily. So he was such a great person that he really was very connected to the Creator and to Hashem. Blessed is his portion above and below. How many treasures await him? So in the world to come. But go your way till the end be. So this is a quote from Daniel, which is one of the prophets. So it says in the English translation, but go you your way till the end be, for you shall rest and stand up for your allotted portion at the end of the days. So I was looking at Daniel and I saw this quote. And it says, Rabbeinu Bachya says on this verse in Daniel that this language that uses is to say that when these type of people pass from this world, when these righteous people pass from this world, this language is to show that they're going to come back in Chiyat Mitim. They're going to come back in the resurrection of the dead after Messiah and Mashiach comes. So now I want to share with you another story. And this was a story about Rabbi Shimon. And so as you all know, I'm sure that he was very learned. He not only authored the Zohar, but he was a master in a lot of different aspects of Torah, of just general learning. So everyone was very surprised when the day after Rosh Hashanah, he didn't study. Rather, he went to his nephew's house and he began to tell them, you need to give charity, you need to give charity, you're not giving enough charity, and you need to make like a ledger saying how much you gave. So they didn't understand, but they said, you know what, my uncle is this amazing person, so I'm sure it makes sense what he's saying, and they promised, and Rabbi Shimon left. So a year later, they got another really strange visit from the Roman soldiers. So they lived in the Roman kingdom, and they got a visit from the Roman soldiers, and they said that you're not paying your taxes. There's someone that's saying you sold silk and you're not paying your taxes to the government. And they're telling them, no, of course we paid our taxes. We have a list, but the Roman soldiers didn't listen and they just took them into jail. So when Rabbi Shimon heard that his nephew was in jail, he ran to the jail and he said, so where is the notes that I told you to keep about your charity? And they said, here. And they saw that Rabbi Shimon saw that they gave almost 600 dinar, which let's say it's $600, and they were just $6 short. So he said, you know, do you have any money with you? Maybe we can just fix this right now. So they had exactly $6, 60 dinar with them, sewed into their garments as like emergency money. So Rabbi Shimon took the money, he gave it to one of the like people who were there, and immediately they were released. So the nephew comes to Rabbi Shimon and he's like, what's going on? Like, I know you have to have a reason for this. It couldn't have just been a coincidence. So Rabbi Shimon explains to him, so this past Rosh Hashanah, a year ago, I went into the upper world and I saw that the government would demand 600 dinar. That's why I told you to give charity to counteract the decree. So then the nephew goes, then why didn't you just tell us that? We would have done it anyways. But Rabbi Shimon says, but then you wouldn't have done the good deed or the mitzvah for its own sake. So what does this mean? Sometimes we do things that are nice and are good, but we think about what we're going to get in return. we never think about like, oh, you know, maybe this other person really needs it. Maybe it's not just about me and I can check it off my list. Oh, I did something good today. So hopefully we'll start to really think about other people when we're doing good and not just about ourselves. And then I'm going to finish off with one more story. And this is about the Baal Shem Tov, which is another great rabbi and Kabbalist. And it says that, so the Baal Shem Tov was known as kind of like a miracle worker. And there was a couple who their daughter, they said was going crazy. It seemed like she was possessed and they didn't know what to do. So they heard that there was this man named the Baal Shem Tov and they called for him. So on his journey to the town that they were living in, he passed an inn. And you know, when it gets dark, you don't just keep riding during that time. You have to go and eat and rest. So they went into the inn and they see that everyone is very, very sad. And he asks around like, what's going on? Why does everyone look so sad? So they say that the like ruler of the town is saying that the Jews in the town can't keep Shabbat. They can't have bleeps. They can't have circumcisions. They can't do anything that they want. And also on top of that, they have too many taxes. They have really bad punishments. Everything is really, really bad. So the Baal Shem Tov asked them like, why would the ruler be doing this? And they say, well, he has this daughter and she seems like she's like really possessed. Like there's something wrong with her. She hasn't been acting normally. So the ruler doesn't know what to do. So he's thinking maybe it's the Jews' fault that his daughter's acting this way. So Baal Shem Tov says, well, maybe I can help him. So, but the ruler doesn't really want his help. He went to a bunch of doctors and he says the Baal Shem Tov doesn't even have like any qualification for this. What is he going to do? How does he know how to do anything? Baal Shem Tov says, all I need to do is whisper something into her ear. So, I mean, the ruler obviously is desperate at this point. So he says, you know what? Fine. Come to my home and do whatever you need to do. I just want my daughter to return back to normal. So the Baal Shem Tov comes to the daughter and she's really like just laying in bed. Like she's very like not healthy at all, but he comes to her and whispers in her ear a part of the Talmud or like a tractate. So it's kind of like a story about Rabbi Shimon. So the story goes like this. So once the king of Rome decreed that Jews weren't able to observe any of their commandments or mitzvot, and to abolish the decree, it was chosen that Rabbi Shimon would be known to, since he was known to abolish the decrees, he was chosen this time as well to abolish the decree. So when Rabbi Shimon began his journey to go abolish the decree, Hashem or God sent an evil spirit into the body of the Roman emperor's daughter. So this young woman, similar to the ruler's daughter in the story, lost her mind. She began acting very strange, but the only thing that she actually said that was understandable was, send for Rabbi Shimon to heal me. I just need Rabbi Shimon. So when Rabbi Shimon arrived in Rome, the king's messengers automatically found him and they told him, you need to go to the emperor's daughter right now. So Rabbi Shimon comes, he understands, and he tells the spirit, evil spirit, I command you to leave the king's daughter. So the spirit listened to Rabbi Shimon and he left and the daughter recovered. So the king says, well, you know, I need to pay you back somehow. Tell me whatever you want and I'll help you. So Rabbi Shimon goes around the office of the king and he finds the decree that says the Jews can't keep their commandments and he tears it up and he says, that's all I need. Thank you. So Baal Shem Tov finishes telling this to the daughter of the ruler, and he looks at the ruler, and he says, Baal Shem Tov says, no, nothing bad will happen to you if you just let the Jews in your town keep their commandments, and I promise you that your daughter will be cured. And he asks him, like, do you agree with this? Will you allow them to do this? And he says, yes, of course, I don't care. Like, I just want my daughter to be healed. So So the Baal Shem Tov goes back to the daughter and he says, just as Rabbi Shimon commanded the spirit to leave, I also command this spirit to leave. And a very long silence followed. It was a very long time. And then the daughter gets up and she doesn't understand, why is there a man in her house? So she looks at her dad, and her dad realizes finally his daughter's back to normal. So then on the way to where he was originally going to the other couple, he realizes that they already had gotten healed, like they didn't need him anymore. So just to finish off, what I learned from this story was that sometimes when we're on our way to do something good, if we take a little bit of a detour to try to help even more with other people, we really can get like two birds with one stone. Because sometimes by on your way to do good, you get tested badly, but also you get tested good. And you have the opportunity to do more good than you even intended. So now I'm going to welcome my brother Yuda to share with you guys something else.
Hello, everyone. I'm going to start off with a section in the Zohar Chadash, the first part of Zohar Chadash, and it's talking about when Rabbi Shimon got sick before he passed away. So, שנו חכמים, כשחלה רבי שמעון בן יוחאי, נכנסו לפניו רבי פנחס ורבי חייא ורבי אבאו. So, when רבי שמעון got sick, רבי פנחס, רבי חייא, and רבי אבאו came to visit him. אמר לו, מישהו עמוד העולם שוכב. So when they walked in, they saw רבי שמעון was lying on his sick bed, and they said, the person who is the pillar of the world is lying down. Sorry. אמר להם, לא בדין של מעלה, מעיינים בדיני, כי אני רואה שאיני ניתן למלך, ולדיין של מעלה, כי אני איני כשר בני אדם. So Rabbi Shimon answered them, Rabbi Shimon answered them that, don't worry, the judgment of all other people is not like the judgment on me. Because other people, when they're judged, you see the angel of death comes to visit them. And with me, the angel of death hasn't shown up. So my judgment's going to be different, Rabbi Shimon is telling them. Ela, din hazeh sheli, HaKadosh Baruch Hu dan oto, ולא בית דינו. והיינו שאמר דוד בתפילתו לפניו ששפטן אלוקים בריב הריבי. So Rabbi Shimon is saying, normally, when judgment comes on someone, it's not God himself judging them. It's his court. With me, God is judging me directly. And it brings a pasuk from Tehillim that King David said that God is my that God judges me and he fights my wars. Mechen Shlomo amar, and also King Solomon said, la'asot mishpat avdo, to do the judgment of his servants, hu levado velo acher, him by himself and not his court. Ki lamanu she'adam shochev בית הדין של מעלה מסתכל בדינו. So we learned, the Zohar is saying, we learned that when someone is lying down, meaning if someone's asleep or in their sick bed, the heavenly court starts looking into their file. יש מהם הנוטים לכף זכות שמראים זכותו של האדם, יש מהם הנוטים לכף חובה המראים החטאים של האדם. So within the court there are those that look at how much good the person did, and there are those that look at how much bad the person did. There's both sides to it in the heavenly court. Va'adam yotze min hadin kmo shehu tzarich, and whichever side is more, that's the judgment that is passed on that person. Aval mi shedan oto ha'melech ha'elyon ha'shulet al hakol, but if somebody is judged directly by God, by the judge himself. הוא טוב, ואין האדם יכול להיות בדין ההוא אלא טוב. That judgment is good, and the person who's being judged can only be seen as good. מה הטעם הוא? כי למדנו מידותיו של המלך העליון נוטים תמיד לזכות. Because when you're judged directly by God, God is the ultimate giving a merciful force. So when once someone is judged directly by God, it can only come out good. והוא כולו צד הרחמים, הוא ידעו לסלוח חטאים אבונות, and he is the aspect of mercy, and it is within his hands to forgive sins. זה שאמר כי עמך סליחה, because with you it brings a verse from the from Tehillim, I believe. כי עמך סליחה, so with you is the forgiveness. ולא עם אחר, and not with somebody else. ומשום זה, and because of this, ביקשתי לפניו שהוא ידין דיני. So that's why Rabbi Shimon is saying, I requested from God so that he'll judge me personally. ואני הכנסתי י"ג מידות הרחמים, and I took the 13 attributes of mercy אל פתחי העולם הבא, to the gates of heaven, שלא העבירו אותם שם חוץ מן האבות, that nobody except for the forefathers, that's Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, was able to pass there. ולא היה מי שיעקב אותי, and there was no one there to stop me. ועוד שלא ביקשתי מהם רשות, and I didn't ask permission either. זה רבי שמעון talking. אמר רבי שמעון דבר, וראו מיטתו. שרבי שמעון לא היה שם. So from this point, when Rabbi Shimon started talking, the three people who were with him, Rabbi Pinchas, Rabbi Chiya, and Rabbi Avahu, they couldn't see him. He wasn't on the bed anymore. He disappeared. Tamu, ואף אחד מהם לא יכול לדבר בפיו. They were shocked, and none of them could form any words. מרוב פחד שהיה להם, because they were terrified. I mean, one second he was there, and one second he disappeared. בעוד שהיו יושבים, עלו להם ריחות של פסמים מרובים. While they're sitting there, trying to figure out what happened, they start smelling this intense smell of perfumes, and like really good smells. ונתחזק כוחו של כל אחד ואחד מהם, and they were strengthened. עד שראו את רבי שמעון, and at that point they were able to see רבי שמעון again, and he hadn't moved, he was still in the bed. והיה מדבר דברים למישהו, ולא היו רואים שם אחר חוץ ממנו. And they didn't see anybody there besides for him. So they saw him talking, but they couldn't hear anybody answer back, and they didn't see who was talking to, but it was clear he was talking to somebody that they couldn't see. לאחר זמן, after a little while, אמר להם רבי שמעון. רבי שמעון turned to them and said, ראיתם משהו? Did you guys see something? He's asking this of the three people who came to visit him. אמר לו רבי פנחס. רבי פנחס says, no, I didn't see anything. אלא כולנו תמהים על שלא ראינו אותך במיתתך זמן רב. In fact, the three of us were sitting here shocked because for a little bit there we couldn't see you. וכשראינו אותך, and when we saw you, עלו אליך ריחות פסמים של גן עדן, the smell of the Garden of Eden surrounded you, ושמענו קולך מדבר, ולא ידענו מי מדבר עמך. So we heard your voice, we heard your voice talking, but we didn't know who you were talking with. אמר להם, ולא שמעתם דיבורים אחרים חוץ משלי, and you didn't hear any, so Rabbi Shimon is asking, you didn't hear anybody else's voice? אמרו לא, they said no, we didn't hear anything. אמר להם, אין אתם ראויים לראות מראה עתיק יומין. So Rabbi Shimon says, based on this, you're not worthy to see the sights of Atik Yomin, which literally translates to the ancient days, but it refers to a spiritual, very high spiritual level. Amar lehem, omar lechem davar. So he says, I'll share with you one thing. Tamani al Rabbi Pinchas shelo ra'a. I'm kind of shocked that Rabbi Pinchas didn't see. Sha'ani ro'e oto ata ba'olam ahu, because I can see him now in the world to come. Lemata memekom Rabbi Elazar bani, that he's right, that he's right next to my son Rabbi Elazar. ואתה שלחו בשבילי מלמעלה, והראו לי מקום הצדיקים לעולם הבא. So now, so Rabbi Shimon is saying, this is one of the things that that happened to me while I was up visiting the upper world. So he says, so they sent me from down here to upstairs, and they showed me the place of tzaddik, the place of the righteous people in the world to come. Beloni tashel mekomi belibi chutz im achiyah sheloni. And I didn't feel like I belonged in any place in the world to come except for next to the prophet Achiyah Sheloni, who, if you don't know who he was the person who, he was the prophet who told Yeravam ben Nevat, who was king after King Solomon, that he would become king. He crowned King Yeravam. Okay. וביררתי מקומי ובאתי. ובאו עמי 300 נשמות הצדיקים. So once I had my, once it was clear to me where my place was, ולמעלה מהם היה האדם הראשון. So 300 righteous souls came with me, and above them was Adam from the Garden of Eden. שהיה יושב אצלי והוא היה מדבר עמי. So I had a conversation with Adam. הוא ביקש שלא יתגלה חטאו לכל העולם חוץ ממה שאמרה התורה עליו. So אדם הראשון, or Adam, basically asked Rabbi Shimon, please don't reveal what my sin was more than what is already written in the Torah itself. ונתרסה באילן ההוא שבגן עדן, and let it be covered by this tree that's in the Garden of Eden. Sha'olam eno yodea mahu, because the world doesn't know what it is. Vani amarti lo, and I told him, hare chaverim gilu cheto, the friends, meaning Rabbi Shimon and his students, already revealed his the secret of what his sin really was. Amar ze shigilu achaverim benehem tov yafe, says that this that it was among you, that's fine. Aval leshar bnei haolam lo, but please don't reveal it to the whole world. Ma hatam, why? Uki chas HaKadosh Baruch Hu al kibudo velo ratza legalot avono lakol ela beoto ha'etz sheamar she'achal mimeno. So this is because God was making sure to protect his honor or his pride, as if God could have honor or pride, so that nobody would know the real sin of Adam. So he hid it within the secret of whatever the fruit was that Adam ate from in the Garden of Eden. There's different opinions. Some say it was pomegranate, some say it was wheat, some say it was a fig, but the secret behind what fruit it was, that's where the secret to what the sin really was is. והקדוש ברוך הוא גילה לי ברוח הקודש ולחברים שידברו ביניהם הם, ולא לגלות לקטנים שבחברים ולאותם שיבואו לעולם. So God revealed to me and to my students that we'll be able to discuss it between us, but not so that we could reveal to the lesser students and to everybody who will come into the world later on. Kiu davar shelo kol anashim mevinim oto vetoim bo, because it's not something that everyone will be able to understand, and that some people, and this is Rabbi Shimon talking, it's not something that everyone will be able to understand, and they'll make mistakes and assumptions because they won't understand it fully. But ken en legalot cheto, and that's why Adam was saying not to reveal his sin. Velo mishum achet shechata shegadol hu, not because it was a big sin, not because he was embarrassed about the sin, but he was making sure to protect the honor of God. Ela mishum kevod Hashem ha'elyon, shebnei adam enam nizarim bo, because he wanted to protect the honor of God, since people can't truly grasp what it means. Vekatuv ze shemi leolam, shepirusho la'alimo, ki yavo lishol ma she'en tzarich. So basically he's saying that he brings this verse, this is my name forever. It's kind of a cryptic verse. He's saying it's the idea behind this verse is to hide him, so that they'll come to ask, because if they don't hide these things that people won't understand, people will come to ask things that aren't needed. Maybe they'll turn to God to look, and many will fall. Mahu venafan menuav. What does this mean? Many will fall. Kach pasakti. Chadal zeh hamlamed et Hashem akadosh lakol. So Rabbi Shimon said, this is my decision. This is my decision for the generations to come. Someone who teaches the holy name to everyone, who nofel venispas beoto avon yoter mehem, he actually falls worse than the people that he was teaching. Shekatuv venafal memenu rav. Arav nofel venitpas beoto avon. So someone who teaches the holy name, meaning the deepest secrets of Kabbalah, to people who are not ready, then the person who's teaching actually falls worse than anybody who he was trying to teach. So Rabbi Elazar now comes up to his father, to Rabbi Shimon. Amar lo, avi, ma ani sham. So Rabbi Elazar wants to know about his place in the world to come. He's like, since you're already there, you mind taking a look? Amar lo, ashrei chelkecha bani, don't worry about your place in the world to come. You have an amazing place in the world to come. Zman rav yesh lo tikaver etzli, you have a long life ahead of you. It's going to be a while before you're buried next to me. Aval ba'olam ahu, makom sheli v'shelcha birarti, but in the world to come, I already checked out both my place and your place in the world to come. Ashrehem atzedikim shehem atidim shaveach la'adon ha'olam. Blessed are the righteous that in the future will have the chance to praise the master of the world. Kilu ha'malachim v'ameshartim shelafanav, like the angels and servants that he has before him. Zeh shneimar, ach tzedikim yodu lishmecha, yeshvu yishar emet panecha. So then he brings a verse that righteous people will thank your name, meaning God's name, and they will sit before you. So that's a little about Rabbi Shimon talking about what he saw in the world to come. The next part is from Zohar Vayechi, and this is. This is about when Jacob was on his deathbed. He called all of his sons together, and he said that he's going to tell them ma'ikre ba'acharit hayamim, in the end of days. Now, before I start, it's generally thought along a lot of the commentaries on this section of the Torah say that within these verses is the secret to when the final redemption is going to come. And so this section as well goes a little bit into that. Rabbi Abba patach ve'amal, pana el tfilat ha'ar ve'gomer. So first, Rabbi Abba opens with a different verse that says that he turned to the prayer of the destitute, to the one who has nothing, and he didn't like make fun of it. So Rabbi Abba is saying we've already discussed this verse, and the question that we had on it, pana, haya tzarich lomal hakshev, hikshiv, o shama, ma'u pana. So he's saying, why did it use the word turn? It should have used the word he listened or he heard, but why use the word he turned to the prayer? Meshiv ela kol tfilot ha'olam. So he said all the prayers of the world, dainu tfilat rabim, that are when many people pray together, like in a minyan, hen tfilot, these are regular prayers. Aval tfilat yachid, but when someone prays alone, it takes a lot more work, a lot more effort to get that prayer accepted if someone is praying alone. כי מטרם שהתפילה נכנסת לאתר במקומה, because before the prayer gets to where it's supposed to be going, משגיח בא הקדוש ברוך הוא, מסתכל בה, God comes and looks at the prayer, הוא מסתכל בה בונותיו ובזכותו של אותו אדם, and he looks at what the person who's making the prayer, this is when they're praying alone, what they did right, what they did wrong, מה שאינו עושה כן בתפילת הרבים, but he doesn't do that when people pray together in a minyan, שכמה הן התפילות שאינם מן הצדיקים, because no matter how many of the prayers in a minyan that aren't from righteous people, ונכנסות כולן לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא, ואינו משגיח בעבודתיהם, but when people pray together, God isn't so detail-oriented about each prayer, he lets them all pass through together. פירושו, so the explanation of this is, שמהפך התפילה ומסתכל בה מכל צד, ומסתכל באיזה רצון נעשה התפילה. So what does it mean that he inspects the prayer and he inspects the person? He says, from which desire is the person praying? ומי הוא האדם שהתפלל תפילה זו? And who is the person who's praying? ומה הם מעשיו, and what has he done in his life? לפיכך צריך האדם שהתפלל תפילתו בציבור. And that's why it's better for a person to pray with a minyan. מהו הטעם? What's the reason? משום שלא ביזה את תפילתם, אף על פי שאינם כולם בכוונה ורצון הלב. So the second half of the verse that we brought before, that he didn't make fun of their prayers, it starts, so the first half of the pasuk is in singular, and the second half of the pasuk is in plural. So the second half of the pasuk is in plural, meaning he didn't make fun of their prayers because what it's talking about when someone prays in a minyan, God doesn't look for what's wrong with the people, with the people in the minyan when they're praying together, all the prayers pass through. בשיעור הכתוב פנה אבל תפילת הערר שרק לתפילת יחיד פונה להסתכל בה. So only when a person prays alone does God use the magnifying glass. אל תפילת רבים לא בזה תפילתם אף על פי שאינם רצויים. So even if the people who are praying together are not necessarily worthy of getting their prayers accepted, it's accepted anyway.
וכפשוטו שמקבל תפילתו, אלא שזה יחיד שנכלל ברבים.
So it brings another explanation of the same verse. So he's saying when it's the first half that's in singular, it's saying what does it mean that he turned to the prayer of the one who has nothing? It means that he accepts the prayer of the single because it's of the singular person, because it's swept up with the group, meaning it's still better, it's still saying to pray with the minyan, but that a person doesn't have to worry, when someone is praying with the minyan, they don't have to worry if they're good enough to get their prayer accepted, because the minyan carries them through.
על כן תפילתו כתפילת רבים. ומי הוא יחיד שנקרא ברבים? הווה אומר שזה יעקב.
So what does it mean that this person, so who's it talking about specifically when it says that there's a single person who's brought together with the many. So it's saying it's talking about Yaakov Avinu.
Shehu kalul bebet tzadim,
because he is made up of two sides, yamin u'smol, the right and the left,
shehem Avraham v'Yitzchak,
which correspond to Abraham and Isaac.
Nekara el banav v'hitpalel tefilato aleihem.
So now we're going full circle back to our main point of discussion. So when Jacob called his sons to his deathbed, he prayed over them. Meaning, so in the Torah, the last part of the book of Genesis, Jacob calls all of his sons together, and it seems like he's giving a sort of prayer right at the end over each of his sons.
ומי היא התפילה המתקבלת בשלמות למעלה? היא התפילה שלא יכלו בני ישראל בגלות.
So what is this prayer that he did that was accepted above? It's the prayer that the Israelites weren't able to pray during the exile. So Jacob saw the exile coming, and he made sure to have a prayer to cover all the time that the Israelites were going to be in exile.
Pirush.
So let's go deeper.
שכל תפילה שהיא בעד השכינה, היא מתקבלת בשלמות. Every prayer that is made within the presence of the Shechina is accepted fully. וכשישראל בגלות שכינה עמהם, על כן נחשב התפילה כמו בעד השכינה ומתקבלת בשלמות. And when the Israelites are in exile, the essence of God goes with them, and that's why even when they pray from exile, it's considered that the prayer is accepted fully.
באותה שעה שיעקב קרא אותם, נסתלקה ממנו השכינה.
And that, at that same point where Jacob called them, the Shekhinah, the essence of God, left him.
וכבר בערוע, and we already explained this, why? ובואו ראה, בשעה שיעקב היה קורא לבניו,
when Jacob called his sons, נזדמנו שם אברהם ויצחק, Abraham and Isaac came to visit, והשכינה עליהם, and they brought the essence of God with them. והשכינה הייתה שמחה ביעקב, and the essence of God was happy within Jacob, להתחבר עם האבות, to connect with the forefathers, להתקשר עם נפשם יחד, להיות מרכבה. So they tie their souls together to become the chariot of God.
בשעה שפתח יעקב ואמר,
when Jacob started his speech and he said hasfu vegomer ba'acharit hayamim, when he got to the word ba'acharit hayamim, at the end of days,
ba'acharit zohi hashchina,
the word ba'acharit, the word at the end or after, that word corresponds to the essence of God, shehi sof hasfirot, because it's the end of the sefirot, because the shechina is also malchut.
בזה שאמר אשר יקרא אתכם באחרית הימים.
So when he says, when I'll tell you what will happen to you at the end of days, שיזכיר את הגלות, he was talking about the exile.
נתן עצבות בשכינה ונסתלקה.
So the essence of God or מלכות got sad and went away.
ואחר כך החזירו אותה בניו,
and then his sons brought it back,
על ידי הייחוד שעשו בדיבורם, שפתחו ואמרו שמה ישראל.
So his son saw that the Shekhinah, that Shekhinah or Malchut was trying to leave, and they brought it back by saying שמה ישראל.
באותה שעה העמיד אותה יעקב, ואמר ברוך שם, ואמר ברוך שם,
and he said the verse that you say after שמה ישראל or after ענה בכוח.
ונתיישבה שכינה במקומה,
and then the essence of God or מלכות sat back, was put back in its place.
שואל, מה הוא קריאה כאן?
So it says ויקרא יעקב, that Jacob called his sons. What does it mean called to his sons?
משיב, אלא הקריאה היא כדי לקיים את מקומם שהיא המלכות המכונה מקום.
So he's saying this word kriya is talking about to make sure that their foundations are stable in this case in malchut.
Shema kriya shekaram kashar otam beshosham nekayem otam lemala beshosham velamata beolam hazeh.
So he made sure that their foundations are stable both in this world and in the next world.
Bore, come and see, bechol makom shekatuv kriya hi keofen hazeh.
So now it's saying every time you see the word in Hebrew is kriyam, which means to call. Every time you see this word, someone is being tied to their source in the upper world.
Shekatuv vayikra Moshe le'Hoshea bin Nun Yehoshua.
Moses called Hoshea bin Nun. He called him Joshua.
Sheya kedei lekayem mekomo shehu hamalchut.
So Moses was making sure that Joshua was tied to where he was supposed to be spiritually in Malchut.
Mechen vayikra shemo Yaakov.
And also earlier on in the book of Genesis, when Isaac named Jacob, he says vayikra shemo Yaakov, and he called his name Jacob.
Vekatuv vayikra lo kel Elokei Yisrael.
And then when Jacob is talking to God, so he says, and he called him God, the God of the Israelites.
שקיים מקום הזה בשם הזה שקרא לו, כי קריאה היא לקיום ולחיזוק. So he's saying, oh, so the Zohar basically brings all these different examples throughout the Torah of the word call, the word kriya or vayikra, meaning to tie somebody to their source, to give them a strong foundation. Shlechora, eze kiyum yeshkan. So now it's asking, well, what about here? So it's going to bring one verse where it doesn't seem to agree. Umeshiv, kenu vaday, shegam hakriya shebekan, hu lekasher hu lekayem kiyum lemala. So there's a verse that it brings in the book of Jonah. So there's this verse that doesn't seem to fit right, because Jonah's whole story was that he didn't want to save the city of Nineveh because he didn't believe that they were worthy of being saved. So it doesn't seem to fit. So he's saying no here too. שגם הקריאה שבכאן הוא לקשר ולקיים קיום למעלה, ומהו? הוא כי סידור השבח לאדונו וכל הדברים שמתפללים לפני אדונו נותנים קיום ותוקף לאדונו. So he's saying, so here it wasn't that they were trying, that he wanted to, that they were tying them to Malchut, he was tying them to their place above. What does that mean? So it's saying, the order of the praise to his master, meaning God, בכל הדברים שמתפללים לפני אדונו, and everything that we pray to God, all the set of all the prayers that we do every morning to God, they almost help stabilize and they give more strength to God. Now, חס ושלום, we could give anything to God. But it's talking about Zeir Anpin in this case. Shemar'e beze she'akol talui bo ve'lo b'makom acher, and it shows through this that everything is tied to him and not something else. Everything in existence is tied to God and not something else. Ke'en ze ve'ikra Yaakov el banav. So just like this, when Jacob called his sons, haynu shekiyem otam bekiyum shalem, he gave them a very perfect foundation. Ken ze veikra el moshe shenitkayem al yedei ze bekiyumo. And also when it brings another the first verse of Leviticus of the book of Vayikra, says Vayikra el Moshe, that God called Moshe. Amar Rabbi Yitzchak, alef shebemila veikra. So Rabbi Yitzchak, now that we're talking about that first verse in Leviticus, Rabbi Yitzchak wants to look into it more. So the Aleph in the first word of the book of Vayikra is smaller than normal. Lama yiktana? Why is it smaller? Im Vayikra yora kiyum mechizuk. So if the whole idea of the word Vayikra has to do with strong foundations and with strengthening, how come specifically this word has a smaller letter? אמר לו, נתקיים משה בשלמות מחמת הקריאה ולא בכולו, כי פירש מחמת זה אשתו. זה מאשתו. So it's saying, Moshe by himself was given the full foundation, but because he had separated from his wife, so there's a story there that basically whenever God called Moses, Moses would separate from his wife. He would stay away from his wife, and then he would go to the Holy of Holies to talk to God. Umishum ze katuv alef tana, and that's why it's written in a small alef. Besifrei rishonim amru she perushato meishto hu shevach velo giraon. So Rav Ashlag here acknowledges that there are many commentaries on that section in the Torah that say that it actually wasn't a bad thing that he separated from his wife, then it was actually something that was praiseworthy. Aval anachnu kach lamadnu, but here in the Zohar, this is how we're learning it. Ma shenistalek meishto v'nitdabek lemala. something because he separated from his wife and he cleaved to the upper worlds, מוצריך שיתקשר למעלה ולמטה. But ideally, one is supposed to tie the upper and the lower together. דהיינו גם באשתו ואז הוא שלם. So, which means also with his wife, and then he'll be perfect. בפרישה מאשתו הוא גרעון לו. And that's why from this aspect, it seems that it lowered the level of Moses to separate from his wife. ועל זה רומזת אלף זעירה כנל. And that's why the אלף is small. ועוד, and another explanation, אלף קטנה רומזת במקום קטן היא. The small aleph hints to coming from a small place. כלומר, שהקריאה הייתה ממקום קטן, that the calling was from a small place. What does it mean from a small place? שהוא מלכות, from מלכות, because מלכות is the lowest of the ספירות. קטן שהוא גדול בהתחברותו למעלה, וזרנפין שהוא סוד משה. Why is מלכות considered קטן? Because Malchut is the lowest, it's the smallest, but it also has the strongest connection to the above, to Zeranpin, which is Moshe. Valken, Vayikra el Moshe, kedei shetihye gedula. And that's why God called Moses, so that the Aleph could become big again. Shuel, so he asks another question. Al vayomer ha'asfu. So coming back to what Jacob said to his, kids, when he said gather, why use this word he'asfu, come gather? Shemashma she'od lo ayu sham etzlo. So the very idea that he had to say gather means that they weren't already there. Im ken ma'u vayomar, lemi amar, if they weren't already there, who was he talking to when he said come gather? Umeshiv kmo she'amarnu va'amarta bilvavecha she'amar belachash, that he said it to himself. So he's saying, why does it say it? And he said it because he said it to himself. Klomar, שאמר דבריו למעלה, כמו שאמר לאלן בביור המילה העשו ולא לבנה ואמר. So he's saying that he actually said it to, he said it above, meaning in the spiritual world, and we'll explain what this means right now. שואל, אם אמר לשליחים שיעשו את בניו, if you're going to say that he said it to a messenger to go get his kids, היה לו לומר, עשו ולא העשו. He should have said, he should have told them to go gather, but the grammar in Hebrew means come gather means you're talking to somebody who's already in the room because of the way the Hebrew grammar works. And it brings a proof from another verse that this is how you're supposed to use the word. Rather, it's clear to us, it's talking about, so when he said he'asfu, it's from a place above. Kamal, she'amar he'asfu el shorshehem ha'leonim shebemalchut. When he said come gather, he was talking to their roots above in Malchut. She'itasfu bekesher shalem, that they'll be gathered in a complete binding, b'yichud echad, in one unification. ואגידה לכם, שואל מהו אגידה, and I will tell you, so what does it mean, and I will tell you, ומשים שהוא סוד החוכמה, כלומר, ואגידה יורש שימשיך להם סוד החוכמה. So when he said this word, and I will tell you, it's talking about the secret of חוכמה. רבי יוסי שאל את רבי שמעון, אמר לו, so רבי יוסי now asks רבי שמעון, ואגידה או ויגד או ויגידו, וכן כל מקום שנאמר הגדה, למדנו שהוא סוד החוכמה. So he's saying, it seems like, because earlier on in the Zohar, it talks about other forms of this same word, agada or vayaged, is that every time we talk about this word, it's talking about the secret of חוכמה. למה יש במילה זו סוד החוכמה? What is the connection between this word and the secret of חוכמה? אמר לו, so Mishmona answers, Mishum shehi milah haba'a b'gimel dalet b'li pirud b'nehen. Because this is the only word where the letters gimel and dalet, which are after each other in the Hebrew alphabet, this word, they're right after each other and there's no separation between them. Why is that significant?
שרומז על ייחוד השלם, because it's a hint to complete unification, כי גימל הוא סוד יסוד, because גימל is the secret of יסוד, דלד הוא סוד מלכות, and דלד is the סוד of, is the secret of מלכות. וזהו סוד החוכמה, כי, and this is the secret of חוכמה, כי מילה הבאה בשלמות בסוד האותיות, the word that is perfect in the secret of the letters gimel and dalet kach hu kshehen besod hachokhma, and that so a word that has the letters gimel and dalet right after each other is the secret of chokhma. Aval dalet bli gimel en shlemut vehen gimel bli dalet, but a gimel without the dalet is not perfect, and a dalet without the gimel is also not perfect. כי גימל דלת התקשרו זה בזה בלי פירוד, because גימל and דלת are tied together without separation. ומי שמפריד אותם, and the person who separates them, גורם לעצמו מיתה, he brings death upon himself. וזה סוד החטא של אדם. And this is the secret of the sin of Adam. שהמשיך אור המלכות ממעלה למטה, because he drew the light of malchut from above to below, v'yifrida miyesod zeranpin v'yifrida dalet min hagimel, and he made a separation between yesod and zeranpin from yesod of zeranpin to malchut and malchut, and he separated between the dalet and the gimel. Mishum ze hagada hi mila shel sod hachokhma, that's why telling hagada is the word of the secret of chokhma. Va'af al pi sheyesh pam yud ben gimel ledalet kegon va'agida. So he's saying, but wait, in our original verse it says va'agida, there's a yud in between the gimel and dalet. Isn't that a separation? So he's saying no. Ki yud romezet gam ken liyesod va'al ken mila zu kachu vaday. So he's saying no. Yud is also a hint to Yesod, because Yud is the first letter of the word Yesod. And so since Yud is also a hint to Yesod, there's no separation between Yesod and Malchut. And the word Vagida is just like every other word that means to tell, and it has a perfect unification between Yesod and Malchut. Afkan Vagida Lachem hu Sod HaChokhma ratza legalot et sof kol ma'aseihem shel Yisrael. So it's saying that Yaakov wanted to reveal what's the end result of everything that's happening in the Torah, everything that happened in the Torah and in the Tanakh, everything that happened up until now, what's the end result of everything? That's what he wanted to reveal to them. Im tomar, and if you want to say shelo gila ma sherata legalot, and if you want to say that he didn't succeed in revealing what he wanted to reveal. Im ken lama ketuv b'Torah hadavar shel Yaakov shalem, why is it written that the word of Jacob is complete? Bechin katkel achar kach velo nishlam hadavar. If his word it uses a word that means went bad, but that means that it didn't happen, and his word wasn't complete. Ela vaday shenishlam. So he's saying no, it was definitely perfect and complete. וכל מה שצריך לגלות גילה וסתם, everything that he needed to reveal, he revealed and then he sealed again. אמר דבר וגילה לחוץ וסתם בפנים. So he said something and he revealed it on the outside, but he sealed it on the inside. ודבר שבתורה אינו מתקלקל לעולם, and something that has to do with the Torah can never go bad. והכל הוא סתום בתורה, and everything is sealed in the Torah, משום שהתורה היא שלמות הכל, because Torah is the perfection of everything, שלמות של מעלה ושל מטה, of above and below, ואין מילה או אות בתורה שתהיה פגומה, and there isn't a word or a letter in the Torah that is damaged or imperfect. In fact, just a sidebar, if there's like in a physical Torah scroll, every single word and letter has to be absolutely perfect. If there's any scratches in it, you have to take it to a sofer to fix it, because every word and letter in the Torah have to be perfect. Ve'Yaakov kol ma sheyatzarich lomar amal, and Jacob said everything he needed to say.
אבל גילה וסתם. But he revealed it and then he sealed it again. ולא פגע מכל מה שרצה לגלות, אפילו עוד אחת. And he didn't, and there was no damage to anything that he wanted to say, even one letter. רבי יהודה ורבי יוסי היו יושבים יום אחד בפתחה שלי, של לוד. So now it tells a little story. Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbi Yossi were sitting one day in the entrance of a city called Lod. Amar Rabbi Yossi le Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Yossi says to Rabbi Yehuda, "Ze she'anu ro'im she'Yaakov berach et banav, anu ro'im mima she'katuv." So he's saying, "This that we know that, you know, the fact that Jacob blessed his sons, we know." That's easy. So we see it says in the Torah that he blessed them. So we know he blessed them. But where do we know what the blessings were? אמר לו הכל הן ברכות שברך אותם כגון יהודה אתה יהודוך אחיך דן ידינמו מאשר השמנה לחמו וכן כולם. So Rabbi Yehuda answers that everything that comes after that is that those are the blessings that he gave his sons. אבל מה שרצה לגלות לא גילה, כי רצה לגלות להם את הקץ. But what, so Rabbi Yehuda then continues to say, but what he wanted to reveal, he didn't reveal. What he wanted to reveal, he didn't reveal, because he wanted to reveal to them the end, meaning the redemption. וביארו שיש קץ לימין ויש קץ לשמאל, and we explained further, what does this mean? What does this end mean? There's an end to the right and there's an end to the left. והוא רצה לגלות להם את הקץ הימין כדי להישמר ולהתאר מעולה שבקץ השמאל. So he wanted to reveal to them the end of the right so that they would be able to stay away from the left column, the judgment, which is represented by the עולה or the foreskin. ומה שגילה להם נודע ונגלה עד שבאו לארץ הקדושה. And what he revealed to them was known and revealed until they made it to the land, until they made it to the Holy Land, the land of Israel. אבל דברים אחרים לא גילה בהתגליה, but other things weren't fully revealed. והם סתומים בתורה בפרשה זו של יעקב ואלו הברכות. And they're hidden in the secrets of this section where Jacob gives the blessings to his sons. So that was a little bit of a long section, but there's one more. This is from the Zohar on Ekev. And it's just a little bit about how blessings work. So it opens with a verse from the portion of Ekev, "Achalta v'savata v'achta Hashem Elokecha," and you will eat, and then you'll be full, and then you bless God. "Mitzvah zu hi levarech et HaKadosh Baruch Hu." So the commandment here is to bless God al kol ma she'achal v'shata v'nehena ba'olam hazeh, on everything that you eat or drink or anything you benefit from. There's a commandment to bless on it. And if the person doesn't bless, they're considered like they robbed, like they stole from God. Like it is written, so it ties it to the verse where someone who steals from their parents. Because the blessings that we say when we bless God pull they bring life from the source of life, Shu Bina, which is Bina. Lishmo HaKadosh Shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu, they bring it from Bina to the name of God. Ulareik Alav Me'oto Shemen HaElyon, and to, I honestly don't know a better word than spritz on him from this upper oil. Shu Shefa Chokhmah, which is the light of Chokhmah, or Misham Baal Limashech Bechol HaOlam, and from there it is drawn to the rest of the world. V'ketuv V'achalta V'savato V'achat Hashem Elokecha. So it brings the verse again. U've'elu Abrachot Merik HaAdam B'Milim Elu. So with these blessings, the person sprays through these words, Shefa Me'oto Makor HaElyon, light, light, blessing, sustenance, sustenance is better, is the best word. Sustenance from that upper source, Shehu Bina, which is Bina. ומתברכים כל המדרגות והמקורות של זרנפין ומלכות, and all of the levels and sources of זרנפין ומלכות are blessed. ומתמלאים בשפע and are filled with sustenance. להריק לכל העולמות, ומתברכים כולם יחד. To spray on all of the worlds and everything is blessed together. ועל כן צריך האדם לשום רצונו בסוד הברכות, and that's why a person should concentrate, meditate when they say the blessing. בשביל שיתברכו האבות שהם חגת דזרנפין, to bless the forefathers, but it's talking about חסד גבוה and תפארת of זרנפין. והבנים and the sons, but when it says sons, it's talking about שהם נהי דזרנפין, נצחות and יסוד of זרנפין. כולם ביחד, all of them together. ומי שמברך לקדוש ברוך הוא מתברך, and anybody who blesses God is blessed. ולוקח חלקו מאלו הברכות, and he takes his peace from these blessings, בתחילה לכל העולם למטה. So he gets his piece of the blessing first before, and then the rest of the world. כיוון ששמו של הקדוש ברוך הוא נתברך משם, since the name of God is blessed from there, חלק ראשון מאלו הברכות יורד ושורה על ראשו של המברך. So since the name of God is being blessed, the first part of the blessing goes first to the head of the person who is blessing. וכבר אמרנו שכתוב, and we've already established that it says, בכל מקום אשר אזכיר את שמי אבוא אליך וברכתיך. Every place, so there's a verse that says where God says, every place that you mention my name, I will come to you and I will bless you. ואחר שאותה ברכה באה ושורה על ראשו של המברך, and after the blessing comes and rests on this person's, on the person, on the blesser's head, מתפשט משם לכל העולם, it goes from there and blesses the rest of the world. It's just a little, that was just a little section on what happened, on why it's important to make blessings on everything that we benefit from. Without further ado, I'd like to introduce my brother, Michael.
Hello, hello. I hope you're back. I hope you have some tea. Welcome back to the Zohar study. Okay. I'm going to be reading my first part in Zohar of Ha'azinu, the section of Idrazuta, the small gathering. So the small gathering was basically the part in the Zohar of when Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai was on his deathbed. When he was very sick before he passed away. Okay, so I am in Idrazuta, Parashat Hazinu in the Zohar, verse 23. Lamadnu beoto yom shRabbi Shimon ratza listelek min haolam. We learned that the same day that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai wanted to leave the world, v'yam mesadel devarav netasfu ha'chavrim etzel Rabbi Shimon, and he wanted to organize his words or his things. And he gathered all the chaverim, the friends, his students, with Rabbi Shimon. V'ayu lefanav Rabbi Elazar beno, v'Rabbi Abba v'shar chaverim, and Rabbi Elazar his son, and Rabbi Abba, and all the other friends were there. V'ayah abayit maleh, and the house, Rabbi Shimon's house, was full. Nasa Rabbi Shimon ena v'ra'ash nitmaleh abayit. Rabbi Shimon saw, he raised his eyes, and he saw that the house was full. ואחר רבי שמעון ואמר, רבי שמעון בר יוחאי started crying, בזמן אחר כשהייתי חולה, another time when I was sick, היה לפניי רבי פנחס בן יאיר, רבי פנחס בן יאיר was in front of me, ועד שביררתי מקומי בגן עדן, and I was preparing my space in גן עדן, in the upper world, חיכו לי עד עתה, and they waited until now. וכשחזרתי, and when I came back, הייתה אש מסובבת לפניי. There was a fire that was surrounding me, that was spinning around in front of me. Me'olam lo nifsak, and it wasn't stopping. Second. Okay. And there was a fire that was spinning and it wasn't stopping. Ve'lo nichnas adam elai ele bershut, and no person could come into the room to come meet me. unless he had permission. ועתה אני רואה שנפסק האש, and now I see that the fire has stopped, והנה נתמלא הבית, and the house is full. בעוד שהיו יושבים, and when they started sitting down, פתח עיניו רבי שמעון, רבי שמעון opened his eyes, וראה מה שראה, and he saw what he saw. That's what the Zohar says. ואש סובבה את הבית, and there's a fire that's surrounding the house. יצאו כולם, everyone went out, ונשארו רבי אלעזר בנו ורבי אבא, ושאר החברים ישבו מבחוץ. So the only people that were left inside the house was Rabbi Elazar, his son, and Rabbi Abba, as my sister said, was the scribe. So Rabbi Abba and Rabbi Elazar were the only ones who were with Rabbi Shimon at that time. Amar Rabbi Shimon said to Rabbi Elazar Benot, to his son, Rabbi Elazar, Tzer u'e im Rabbi Yitzchak yeshno kan. See if Rabbi Yitzchak is here. Ki ani eravti lo, emo lo shisadel devarav, v'yashav esli ashrei chelko. So he said, go see if Rabbi Yitzchak is here, and say to him and make sure he gathers his thoughts, gathers his things and his words, and he should sit by me. Interestingly enough, Rabbi Yitzchak, as mentioned here, has the same death anniversary, or Yaltzeit, or what you want to call it, as Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. It's also Lalag Bomer. Very interesting. Kam Rabbi Shimon. Rabbi Shimon got up, v'yashav, and he sat, v'tzachak, and he started laughing, v'samach, and he was happy. Amar, and he said, Efo hem ha-chaverim? Where are the friends? The friends, the students of Rabbi Shimon. Kam Rabbi Elazar got up, v'ichnisam, and he brought them in. Yashvu lefanav, they all sat in front of him. Nasei adav Rabbi Shimon, v'itpaled tfila. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai raised his hands up, and he prayed. V'ya sameach, and he was happy. V'amar, elu ha-chaverim, shayu nimsaim bevet ha-idra, dainu b'idra rabba, izdamnu kan. And he said to these friends that the people who were found in the first gathering, the Idra Rabba, the great gathering, are here today. They should be here. Yetzu kulam, everyone went out. V'nisharu Rabbi Elazar Beno, v'Rabbi Abba, v'Rabbi Yehuda, v'Rabbi Yossi, v'Rabbi Chiya. So he said that the people who were at the Idra Rabba should be here. So Rabbi Elazar, his son, Rabbi Abba, the scribe, Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Yossi, and Rabbi Chiya were the ones who were inside the house now. B'toch kach nichnas Rabbi Yitzchak. And in that moment, Rabbi Yitzchak came inside. Amar lo Rabbi Shimon, Rabbi Shimon said to Rabbi Yitzchak, Kama yafe chelkecha, how wonderful is your piece, is your part? Kama simcha tzricha litosef lecha biyom hazeh. How happy do you have to, how much happiness do you have to add for this day? Yashav Rabbi Abba achor ketefav. Rabbi Abba sat down behind the shoulders of Rabbi Shimon. Rabbi Elazar lefanav, and Rabbi Elazar was in front of him. Amar Rabbi Shimon, Rabbi Shimon said, Hinei ata sha'at ratzon hu. Now is a time, Rabbi Shimon is saying, of et ratzon. It's a time of desire. V'ani rotze lavo bli busha l'olam haba. And Rabbi Shimon is saying, I want to come to the next world without any embarrassment, without any shame. V'nei dvarim kdoshim shelo giliti ad ata. And there are things that, very holy things that I didn't reveal until now. Ani rotze lagalot lefnei ha-shechina. I want to reveal them in front of the Shechina. Shelo yomu shebichisron nistalakti min ha'olam. So that they won't say that I left this world with some type of chisaron, with some type of lack. And until now, they were hidden in my heart. So I could go with them to Olam Haba. And so this is how it's going to work. This is Rabbi Shimon is saying over to his students, I want to reveal these ideas. So I want Rabbi Abba to write down these words. Rabbi Elazar b'ni yilmod b'peh. And Rabbi Elazar will say it over with his mouth, as in he'll say it over. V'shar ha-chaverim yidovevu b'libam. And the rest of the students should say it in their hearts. So they should say it in their hearts. So they should be quiet while they say it. Say it silently. Kam Rabbi Abba me'achor ektefav. Rabbi Abba got up from behind his shoulders. V'ayah Rabbi Elazar b'no yoshev lefanav. And Rabbi Elazar was sitting in front of Rabbi Shimon. Amar lo Rabbi Shimon. Rabbi Shimon said to him, Kum b'ni, please get up, my son, because someone else is going to sit here. Come, Rabbi Elazar, and Rabbi Elazar got up. Nitatef Rabbi Shimon b'vusho. Rabbi Shimon was wrapped in his clothing. Biashav, and he sat. Patach b'amar. So now he's going to say divrei Torah, a piece of Torah. Lo ametim yahaluka velo kol yordei duma. Right. So it says lo ametim yahaluka kachu v'day. So the pasuk says the dead people can't praise Hashem. And not everyone is going to stay in a level of Gehenom of hell. Kachu v'day, so Rabbi Shimon is saying This is what it means. Shem nikraim etim, that they are called the dead. Ki HaKadosh Baruch Hu nikra chai, the creator, the Hashem, the light, the creator, is called chai, he's called life. V'hu shore ben elu hanikraim chayim, and he is controlling or giving between those who are chayim, the haynu hatzadikim, the righteous people, v'lo im elu hanikraim etim, the haynu ha'rishayim. And he's not giving to the people who are called dead, which are the rishayim, the wicked people. V'sof ha'katuv mochiach shekatuv. And so the last part of that pasuk is proving this. V'lo kol yodei duma, the haynu kol elu hayodim lemalach duma, shisharu begeinom. So what is it talking about? The last part of the pasuk is talking about the people who are going down to a certain level of hell, and that they're going to stay there in that level. But not for the people who are called chayim, not for the people who are the tzaddikim, who are righteous. And because HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants to be in their preciousness or have them close to him. How special or unique is this moment? How different is this moment from the moment that we had in Idra Rabba, the great gathering? Here is Idra Zuta, the small gathering. So how different is the Idra Rabba of Parshat Naso? Ki b'Idra hizdamen HaKadosh Baruch Hu ma'akav tov. Because in the gathering of Rabbi Shimon and his students, the Creator and his chariot come together. V'ata arei HaKadosh Baruch Hu kan. And Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai says here that the Creator was there in this gathering. Sheba'im ha-tzadikim shebegan Eden, and he's coming with the tzadikim, the righteous people from Gan Eden. Ma shelo kara be'idra, what didn't happen in the Idra, in the gathering before. V'HaKadosh Baruch Hu rotze bechvodam shel ha-tzadikim yoter mechavod shel atzmo. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Creator, wants their honor or their kavod of these righteous people more than the kavod of himself. So he wants the tzadikim to have more. He wants the tzaddikim to get the kavod more than he wants the kavod for himself. Kmo shama biruvam shaya mikatel v'oved la'avodah zarah. Like it says in by the psukim or the verses of Yeruvam, that he was oved avodah zarah, that he was worshiping idols. Makadosh Baruch Hu emtino v'lo anisho v'kevin shoshit yado keneged edo hanavi hitavsha yado. So it says that Makadosh Baruch Hu, once Yeruvam was stretching out his hand to strike Ido Hanavi, to strike one of the prophets, his hand, it says here, dried up. Like it says in the pasuk, like it says in the verse. Ba'al she'avad avodah zarah lo katuv, ela al ma she'hoshit yado le'ido Hanavi. So he says that it's not because Yeruvam was worshiping idols, it was because he was trying to hit a tzaddik, or hit a Navi, or stretch his hand against a Navi. Ba'ata HaKadosh Baruch Hu rotze bekavod shelanu. So now HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants the kavod, the honor, the respect of the tzaddikim, because the tzaddikim are all in Gan Eden, that are in Gan Eden came with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, with the Creator. Amar Rabbi Shimon, so Rabbi Shimon said, Hare Avnun Saba kan, here is Rav Avnun Saba, v'saviv lo ayin tzaddikim chakukim be'atarot. So he's saying these are tzaddikim from Gan Eden. So with Rav Hamnun HaSaba, which is a very great commentary in the Zohar, as he's mentioned in the Zohar, and with him come 70 righteous people that have atarot, which are basically crowns or crowns of light that they have on their heads. Umeirim kol echad ve'echad mizohar ziv atika kadisha, and every single one of these people is shining with the shining of the Atika Kadisha, the ancient holiness. Hasatum kol stumim, the concealed of all concealed. V'hu ba b'simcha lishmo elu advarim. And Rav Avnun HaSaba is coming to listen with happiness to these words, Shani umel, that I'm saying over. Bo'ot sh'aya yoshev, Rabbi Shimon sat down, Amar, he said, Hare Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair kan, itkinu mekomo. He said, Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair is here. Make sure he has space to sit or to be there. Nizda'azu ha'chaverim shayu shama. The friends, the students who were there, it says they were shaking. I mean, it's crazy. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai is like on his bed, and he's seeing tzaddikim from Gan Eden, and the Talmidim are like they're freaking out. It's like, this is amazing. And so they got up and they sat in the back of the house, or in the corners of the house. And so they sat in the back of the house because from my, okay, yeah. So I don't want to put in my understanding. So we quote what the Zohar says, that they got up and they sat in the back of the house. And Rabbi Elazar and Rabbi Abba were the only ones who stayed in front of Rabbi Shimon. Amar Rabbi Shimon be'idra Rabba nimtzanu. And so Rabbi Shimon said, in the Idra Rabba, in the great gathering, we found that all shekol ha'chaverim hayu omrim, that all the friends or the talmidim would say, va'ani mahem, and I would be with them. Ata ani omer b'vadi v'chulam yakshivu l'dvarai. Now I am saying by myself, and everyone should listen to my words. Elonim v'tachtonim, the upper worlds and the lower worlds. Asher chilki b'yom hazeh, blessed is my part on this day. Padach Rabbi Shimon v'amar, Rabbi Shimon opened a verse of Torah, and he said, "Ani lo dodi v'alai tishukato." So he takes this verse from Shir HaShirim. It says, "I am for my loved one, and his kisses are on me." Right. So that's the Shir HaShirim. Kol yamim she'ayiti kashu b'olam hazeh. So Rabbi Shimon says, "All the days that I was in this world, bekesher echad nikshalti b'kadosh baruch hu. I was tied with one tie to a kadosh baruch hu. Mishum ze ata, and now." His kiss is on me. And so now, because my whole life I was tied to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I was connected to the Creator, now the entire holy camp of the Creator is coming to listen with great happiness to these concealed things that I'm saying over, with praise of the holy, the ancient holiness. So the concealed of all the concealed, that is explained and hidden from everything. But it's not hidden. It's not differentiated. So he's saying, it's very cryptic language, but the HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Creator, is connected to everything, and everything is connected to him, and he is everything. So the Rabbi Shimon is just explaining what the Creator is. He is connected to everything, and everything is connected to him, and he is everything. It's kind of hard to understand for a human to understand with a limited mind, but this is what Rabbi Shimon says on his deathbed. So that was the first part that I wanted to read. The second part I wanted to read was from the end of Azinu, in verse 215. Rabbi Elazar patach, v'av gam zot. So the pasuk says, he's taking a pasuk from the book of Vayikra. It says that even though they're in the land of their enemies, in that pasuk, it says that even though they're in the land of their enemies, I will still be with them. It's God talking about Bnei Israel. It's the Creator talking about the nation of Israel. Ashrehem Yisrael al kol amim akum. So he's saying that how blessed is the nation of Israel from all the nations, all the other nations. Sha'afal pishi kiso lifnei Adonam. Even though they're angering their master, so the Bnei Israel, the nation of Israel, is making HaKadosh Baruch Hu angry, kiviyachol, like as if HaKadosh Baruch Hu, as if the Creator could get angry. HaKadosh Baruch Hu eno rotze le'azov otam. The Creator still doesn't want to leave them. Shebechol makom shegalu ben ha'amim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu nimtza imahem begalut. Anywhere that the nation of Israel is found in galut, found in exile, he will always be with them. Ze she'ama va'af gamzot bi'otam be'eretz oyvehem. Just like the verse says that even in the land of their enemy, I will still be with them. Rabbi Abba says, "V'av gam zot biyotam." So he takes this quote and he's, "Come and see." Kama hi Abba teKadosh Baruch Hu Israel. How big is the love from the Creator to the nation of Israel? Sha'af al pi shegamul liot begalut ben amim. Even though they caused themselves to go into exile between the nations, Ashchina ena sara mehem leolam. The Shekhinah, which is the essence of God or the female aspect of God, you can see it both ways, isn't leaving the nation of Israel at any time forever. ואל תאמר, you can't say שהם בלבדם נמצאים בגלות, you can't say that they're alone in exile, אלא ואף גם זאת. It says in the pasuk, ואף גם זאת, and even with this. So what does it mean זאת, this? שהיא השכינה נקראת זאת. So it says the שכינה, the female aspect of God, is called זאת. נמצאת עמהם, that she is with them. זה שאמר, אף גם זאת ביותם בארץ אויביהם. Even with this, even with this in the land of their enemy, I will still be with them. So the Zohar brings a mashal, a allegory, a story that teaches you a lesson, basically, or a metaphor. למלך שכעס על בנו, a king who was angry at his son, וגזר עליו עונש שיתרחק ממנו וילך לארץ רחוקה, and he made a punishment for his son to go far away into a far land. שמעה המלכה ואמרה, and so the queen heard this, the queen heard about her son, כיוון שבני הולך לארץ רחוקה, and she said, since my son is going to a faraway land, והמלך השליחו מהיכלו, and the king is sending him away from his chamber, אני לא אעזבנו, I will not leave my son, או שנינו יחד נחזור להיכל המלך, or, so he's saying, either, the queen is saying, so in the allegory, either me and my son will go back together to the chamber of the king, or shninu yachad nesher be'eretz acheret, or together we're going to go to a faraway land. Li'amim pakad ha'melech et ha'malkah, and so a few days pass and the king is trying to find the queen, ve'lo matzah, and he can't find her, ki halcha im beno, because she went with her son. המלכיוון שהמלכה שם, שניהם ישובו. So he said, since the queen is with him, they should both return. So what is this trying to teach us? כך הוא בזמן שיפקוד הקדוש ברוך הוא את השכינה. This is what it's going to be like, or what it was like in Mitzrayim, what it will be like in the times of Mashiach, when the הקדוש ברוך הוא, the creator, is looking for the שכינה, the female aspect of the creator. יפקוד אותה תחילה, he will first try to find or trying to meet with her, ובשבילה יפקוד לבנב, and because of her, he will meet with her son, which is us, בני ישראל, the nation of Israel. זה שאמר, וגם אני שמעתי את נעקת בני ישראל, like it says in the verse, that I've heard the cries of the nation of Israel, מי גרם שאני שמעתי נעקתם? So the question of the Zohar is, how did I hear these cries? כביכול השכינה גלמה. It's as if the שכינה caused the remembering of the cries of Bnei Yisrael, שזכלתי אותה, that I remembered her. זה שאמר ויזכור בריתי, that I remembered my brit, my covenant, דהיינו השכינה נקראת ברית. And ברית, according to the Zohar, is the שכינה, represents the שכינה. וכתוב ויזכור אלוקים את בריתו, it also says in another verse that Elohim remembered his covenant, וכשהקדוש ברוך הוא יחזיר את ישראל מן הגלות, and when the creator will return Israel, will return the nation of Israel from exile, מה כתוב? What does it say? ושב השם אלוקיך את שבותיך ברחמיך. And Hashem, your God, will return you with your mercy. זוהי השכינה, and this is talking about the שכינה, שעליה נאמר, because on her it says, ושב וגומר את שבותיך. So it uses the verse ושב. עוד כתוב, and also says, רצית השם ארציך, Shabbat Shavot Yaakov. Then the Shechina is called Eretz. So it's talking about the Shechina here. Amar Rabbi Yehuda says, "Hale Hashem Tigmelu Zot." So it says, "Hale Hashem Tigmelu Zot." Hare Atem Dor Ikesh Uftaltol. So it says, what does it mean when it says "Hale Hashem Tigmelu Zot"? When it uses the Zot, remember Zot is actually the Shechina, and then later on it says that there are a generation of stubbornness and twistedness, that atem gramtem lehaglot et zot begalut, that you caused, he's saying that Bnei Yisrael, the nation of Israel, caused the Shechina to go into galut. Hala Hashem tigmelu zot zehu hagemul al ma she'asa imachem. So this is how would you say gemul? Gmilut. Do you know? Gemul? Gemul? How would you say gemul? The verse. הלא השם תגבלו זאת. Okay, so זהו הגמול על מה שעשה עםכם. So this is the gemul that he did with you. בכל אלו המעשים שבמצרים, all these actions that were done in Egypt, בכל אלו האותות שעשה לכם, all these symbols that he did for you, זהו הגמול שאתם משלמים לזאת הזו. This is the gemul. This is... Okay, I'm very sorry. I don't remember the translation for this word. So this is the gemul that you're completing for this zot. The zot is the shechina. מי גרם לכם את זה, and who caused this for you? ומשום שאתם, because you, בני ישראל, the nation of Israel, עם נבל ולא חכם, you are not smart, שאינכם מסתכלים בכל הטוב שעשה לכם עד עתה. Because you didn't see all the good that... Gemul means reward. Ah, so gemul is reward. Thank you. So what is it saying here? Zehu ha-gemul al ma she'asa lechem. This is the reward that he did for you with all these actions that are done in Egypt, with all the symbols, right? So all the miracles, all the splitting of the Red Sea, crossing the Red Sea, and then Har Sinai, making sure that everyone lived before, right? During the Red Sea, all the miracles that took place during the Makot, everything that took place was gemul, as we now know, a reward. And this is the gemul she'atem mishlemim lezot hazu. And this is the reward that you're completing for this zot, the shechina, the female aspect. Mi garam lachem et zeh? And who caused this for you? Hu mishum she'atem, because you, am naval velo chacham. Why did you have to give this reward to this zot? Because you were not smart. She'enchem mistaklim b'chol hatov she'asa lachem adata. You weren't looking at what good the HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the creator, did for you. And because of this, you didn't recognize the appreciation. So this teaches us, when you have something good in your life, you have to appreciate, you didn't do it, God gave it to you. So it's an interesting topic. Okay, the next part I want to talk about, we still have a little bit of time, yeah. Still there. I hope everyone's still here. Okay, so the next part I want to talk about is from Zohar Shlach Lecha. We are on... Oh, here we are. Okay, so we are on the Zohar of Shlach Lecha, verse 190. So this is during the time when Rabbi Shimon had, I wouldn't say a vision, but he was having conversations with two messengers from God. So he was having two emissaries, as translation of the Zohar, two emissaries, and he wanted to find out about what was going on in heaven. What was going on there? So we're in the verse 190. Ata Rabbi nechzol ledvarim harishonim shelanu. So the emissaries are saying, now, Rabbi, so Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, they're talking to Rabbi Shimon. Let's go back to the words that we first had. When we come back to our place, and we want to see if we're going to be able to see if we can answer your things. Because before this, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai is going to ask, what's going on in Gan Eden? What's going on in the world to come? What's going on in the upper worlds? We will say to you, so we'll see if you can get permission to hear these things, and we'll say it to you. So it says, so these emissaries are saying, blessed is you, you've had these chut, you have the merit for these concealed lights from every direction, from up and down, from this world and the world to come. אמר רבי שמעון דבר אחד רציתי לדעת. So רבי שמעון said, I want to know one thing. אם תוכלו להודיע לי, if you can tell me, נשים בעולם ההוא, אם זוכות לעולות למעלה, או איך אין שם. He wants to know what happens to women in the world to come. What happens there? אמר לו, אהה רבי, יש לנו בזה סוד יקר. So the emissaries say, it says here, אהה. So אהה רבי שמעון, אהה. So it's a very big secret. Like in legalot asterim isham, but we can't reveal these concealed secrets here. But lech zevi etol reshut. We're gonna go ask permission. Ben amolecha, and we'll say it to you. B'toch kach, And in this moment, parach echad, one disappeared, ve'ne'ela mehem, and he disappeared, ve'alach lo, and he went. וכרגע חזר להם, the next moment he came back, אמר להם, he said to them, מוכן הייתי להיכנס, והיו כולם בעגול אחד. I was ready to go inside, and everyone was in a circle, דהיינו שהיו יושבים בעגול, they were sitting in a circle, שהיו דנים דין של אדם אחד שעמד על פתח גן עדן. So he was in Gan Eden, he was seeing what's going on in Gan Eden. Can you imagine? Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, seeing what's going on in Gan Eden. So he says that they were judging a person in the entrance of Gan Eden. והקרובים אחזו בו, and the cherubs were holding him. ולא נתנו אותו להיכנס שמה, and they weren't letting this person go in. והיה בצער ביניהם, and he was in a very big pain. וצעק צעקות בפתח, and he was screaming in the entrance. ושמעו כל הצדיקים אשר שם, and all the tzaddikim, all the righteous people, heard what was going on. נתאספו, ועתה נתאספו כל בני הישיבה להיכנס למלך המשיח לעיין בידינו, בדינו. And now all the people of the yeshiva are going in to the chamber of the Melech Mashiach, the King of Messiah, to see what would be his judgment. ובאתי להודיע לכם, and I came to let you know. ובחברי זה צריך ללכת שמה, כי חירוז עבר בין כל בני הישיבה שהיו מתאספים לקראת המשיח. So we had to go there, צריך ללכת שמה, we had to go there, because there was an announcement between all the yeshivot, all the schools, that shayu mitasfim likat haMashiach, because they were going to call the Messiah. Lekach ketav echad, and he took one paper or a note, venatan Rabbi Shimon, and he gave it to Rabbi Shimon. Amar kach etze, and he said, take this, vayin b'ma shekatuv sham, and look at it and see what it says, ad shenavo lecha, and until I come to you. Paruchu shnehem, and they both disappeared or went away. Rabbi Shimon lakach haktav, and Rabbi Shimon took this. Rabbi Shimon took this paper. V'ra'a ma she'ra'a be'asodot asher sham kol oto hayom, and he saw what he saw in the secrets that were there the entire day. Balayla, but at night, ra'a ner, he saw a candle, v'nafal alav shena, and a sleep fell on him. And he fell asleep. And he slept until the next day. And when the next day came, and the paper, the note, disappeared. When the day came, no. And then these two emissaries came back. Please get up, Rabbi Shimon. Blessed is your part. Kum, please get up. בשבילך ראינו וזכינו לכמה סתרים אלונים. So we saw with your זכות, or we had the merit for many concealed upper things. כמה שמחה הראו לנו כשנתנו לנו רשות לגלות לך כל מה שאתה רוצה. How much happiness did we have when they gave us permission that we could reveal to you what you wanted. ראש ישיבה עליונה, the head of the upper school of thought, יצא אלינו, came to us, ואמר שאלו בשלום בן יוחאי. He said, how is בן יוחאי, how is רבי שמעון בן יוחאי? וכמו שבן יוחאי פנו לו מכמה ימים, and רבי שמעון בן יוחאי's spot is saved for him for several days, אין מי שיקרב לו, and there's no person who gets close to it, אשרי הוא, he is blessed. רבי, so it's רבי שמעון, כשפרחנו ממך, when we disappeared from you, נכנסו וראינו כל בני הישיבה, so we saw, when we were away from you, we saw all the people who were part of the schools, שמתאספים להיכל אחד, they were going to one chamber, ששם משיח, and there is Messiah. ודנו דין של אותו האדם שעמד על הפתח, and we were making the judgment of this person who was standing in the doorway, in the entrance of Gan Eden. אין לנו רשות לגלות שמה, but we can't tell you his name. נצטער על זה רבי שמעון, and רבי שמעון felt sorry for this. אמר לו, אל תצער, and so they said to him, don't be sorry, רבי, על זה אתה תדע זה בלילה בחלומך, אבל דידנו עליו. So on this, you'll know in the night, in your dream, but we did make a judgment on this person, שגזל משיח, that משיח made a decree, שיהיה האדם ההוא בחוץ בצער הזה, 40 יום, that this person will be in pain for 40 days, לסוף מהם יום, and after 40 days, יצערו לי בדין צער גהנום, שעה ומחצה. And after 40 days, he will have the tzar of he will have the pain of the judgment of Gehenom for Shah Umechetza, which literally means an hour and a half. Bechol Zehu, and everything that he said, Meshum Shiyom Echad, because one day, it's talking about this person who was being judged, Haya Echad Min HaChaberim, there was one person, Mefaresh Divrei Torah, that was saying over certain words of Torah, Kshiyegi Ledaber Echad, Lidvar Echad, Yada Oto Adam Shiyikashel Bo. And so this person, there was another person who was there, and he knew that the person who was saying over the Divrei Torah, he knew that it was going to be not so exact. Vamala Chaverim Shtoku, and he said to his friends to be quiet, Al Tomu Klum, don't say anything, Meshum Shishtaku HaChaverim, and because they were quiet, Nechshal B'Devar Ahu V'Nitbazeh, because they were quiet, he made a mistake in the Divrei Torah, and it was Bizui, it was wasted. Meshum Bizion Ahum, because of this wastedness, Shegam Lo Adam, because this person caused this person who was saying over the Dvar Torah, the word of Torah, because he caused that, Dano Oto B'Din Kashe, they judged him with very harsh judgment. Mishum She'en HaKadosh Baruch Hu Rutzeh La'azov Avon Shel Torah Afilu K'melech Se'era, because HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Creator, doesn't want to leave a sin of Torah, doesn't even want to have even a hair. Doesn't even want to have even a hair of sin. Dano Dinei V'Yatzuk Ha'Bnei Yeshiva, so they made the judgment and everyone went out. V'Ani Sha'alti Reshut Kibino Sheluchai Sha'al She'el Azu. And so afterwards I asked, because Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai wanted to know what happens with the women in the world to come. And so they showed me what I didn't know before. Aha Rabbi, Shisha Echalot Haruli. So Rabbi, they tell Rabbi Shimon, they showed me six chambers. V'kama ta'anugim v'adonim, v'kom sh'aparochet perusha b'gan, kim parochet ahi ul'ala'a en s'chayim nechnasim klal. And so in these six chambers, there are many joys, and this is where the parochet, perusha b'gan, where the parochet is in the gan. Let me just find the place in the English. So very variety of delights and pleasures in the place where the dividing curtain was unfurled in the garden, since from that curtain further on, no males can enter at all. So this part of Gan Eden, there are no males. There are no gvarim ish. Right? There's no males there. So then he says, so in the first sanctuary, we have the first sanctuary of the women. So Batya, the daughter of Pharaoh. So if you don't know, Batya was the daughter of Paro. And she was the one who saved Moshe from the Nile. Moshe Rabbeinu, Moses. So Batya, the daughter of Pharaoh, dwells, and many tens of thousands of virtuous women are with her. So there are tens of thousands of virtuous women. And each of them have a place of brightness and pleasures very commonly. Three times a day, a proclamation resounds. Here comes the image of Moses, the faithful prophet. And they proclaim against the prophet, the Moshe, because Batya was Zoche, she had the schut, she had the merit to save Moshe from the Nile. And so Batya says, praised is my part, so blessed is my part that I brought up this light, that I brought up Moshe Rabbeinu, because she raised him. Second. So Batya goes back to the women and they learn Torah. And it says that they were in the form they were in this world. They were in the same clothing, I guess. Kulan hen b'tzurot, they were in the same form, shayu b'olam hazeh, in this world, v'levush or in a clothing of light. Kamo levushei haschrim, just like the clothing of males, chutz ma she'enam me'irim kol kach levushei haschrim. But they weren't as shining as the males. Mitzvat ha'torah shelo zechu lekayem otan b'olam hazeh, hen oskot behen v'tameihen b'olam ahu. So the mitzvot that they weren't able to do in this world, they were busy with in that world, in the next world. And they were sitting in one chamber. And they were called serene women. Why were they called serene, which means like calm? Because they didn't have any pain in the judgment of Gehenom. And the pains of Gehenom. So that was the first, Batya Bat Paro. The next sanctuary was Serach Bat Asher. If you don't know, Serach Bat Asher was the one who told Yaakov Avinu, Jacob, the patriarch, that Joseph was still alive. So it says Serach Bat Asher was with thousands of women with her, and then three times a day they proclaim in her presence, and so they see the image, Muna, of Yosef HaTzadik, and she's happy. Yotzed l'mechitza echad sheyesh la, and she goes out to the place that she has. Ve'ro'et od surat Yosef, and she sees the image of Yosef. Joseph simcha mishtechevet elav, and she bows down to this image to Joseph. Ve'omeret ashri oto yom she'erati ha'besura shelcha el zkeni. So she says that how blessed is my part that I was able to tell my grandfather Jacob the patriarch that you were still alive, Joseph was still alive. Ahalka chozeret et shar anashim, she goes back with the rest of the men, ve'oskot b'tishbachot ribon ha'olam, they go back to praise the creator, ve'lehodot lishmon, to thank his name. U'kama mekumot v'simcha yesh l'chol echad v'echad, many places there is happiness. Ahalka chozeret la'asok b'mitzvat ha'torah v'ta'amehen, and so they go back to learning the Torah and the reasons that they have for the Torah. V'chal echad, so then that was the second. So batya, serach, the third is yocheved. Who is Yocheved? Yocheved was the mother of Moses. So in the next Echad, we have Yocheved Imo Shel Moshe, Hanavi Haneman. V'chama alafim v'rvot iman, many people are with her. V'hechal ze en machizim klal, they don't make any announcements in this chamber, but three times in every day, she's thanking and praising to the Creator. Hi v'chol elu anashim shima, her and all the women with her. ומזמירות שירת הים בכל יום, and they say the שירת הים, והיא יבדה מתחילת מכאן, תיקח מרים הנביאה. And so she specifically, יוחבד, starts from תיקח מרים הנביאה. מרים was actually יוחבד's daughter. וכל אלו הצדיקים שבגן עדן מקשיבים לכל נעימות שלה, and all the צדיקים, all the righteous people in גן עדן are listening to her beautiful voice. וכמה מלאכים קדושים מודים ושבחים עמה לשם הקדוש. And there are angels, holy angels that are thinking and praising with her to the holy name. So that was Batya, Serach Bat Asher, and Yocheved. The fourth one that we have is Dvorah Neviya, Deborah. V'gam ken kol nashim she'imam odot u'mizmorot b'shira ahi she'hi amra melolam hazeh. And so Zohar says that in that chamber, Dvorah and many other women would say over mizmorim songs that she sang in this world, in the physical world. Aha Rebbe. So, Aha Rebbe, so they say, Aha Rebbe Shimon, Mi ra'a simchat ha'tzadikim v'nashim tzadkinot, tzadkaniyot, ha'ovdin makadosh baruch hu. Who sees this happiness of the righteous people and the righteous women that are working for Kadosh Baruch Hu, lifanai u'lifnim shel elu ha'echalot. Within these chambers, yesh arba'a echalot nistarim shel ha'imaot ha'kdoshot, there are four chambers of the holy women, shelo nimsa'u legalot, that weren't, that didn't go to exile. Ve'en mishra'utan, there are none who've seen these chambers. B'chol yom hen levadan kemo she'amarti lecha v'agbarim gan ken levadan. So it says these chambers are alone, and also the men's chambers are alone. It's describing Gan Eden. It's crazy. It's mind blowing. V'chol laila mitkalim kulam yachad, and every night everyone is coming. They come together. Mishum shishat hazivug hu b'chatzot ha'layla, because chatzot ha'layla is the time of the union, ben ba'olam hazeh, ben ba'olam ha'hu, whether it's this world or the next world, hazivug shel olam ha'hu hu itvagut ha'neshama b'neshama, o be'o. But in the upper world, the union that's created is through two lights, o be'o, light and light, and neshama and neshama, soul and soul. But here in the physical world, it's body and body. Ve'akol kemo shira'ui, so it's everything, it's physical, it's body and body. So he says, these four chambers are called the chambers of the trusting daughters. But I wasn't able to see them. Blessed is the holy righteous people, the men and the women, that are going in the straight path in this world, and that have the merit to enjoy in the next world. If you weren't Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, you wouldn't be in, one second, it would not have been passed on to divulge this to you. Ah, לא ניסה לגלות, to reveal. So if you weren't Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, I wouldn't be able to tell this to you. הזיווג שבעולם ההוא הוא סיפרות יותר מזיווג שנעשה בלום הזה. So the union that's created in the upper world makes more fruits than the fruits that are made in this world. והזיווג שלהם בזיווג של עולם ההוא, בתשוקה שלהם כאחד, כשמתדבקות הנשמות זו עם זו, so when the souls come together in the upper world, when they make a union, עושים פירות, they make fruits, ויוצאים מהם אורות. And from these fruits comes light, ונעשים נרות, and makes candles, והם הנשמות אל הגרים שמתגיירים. And these candles that are made from the union of the two souls in the upper world, that's what makes the soul of a convert. וכל אלו הנשמות שנודות מאלו הזיווגים, and every soul that's born from this union, נכנסים להיכל אחד, they go into one chamber. And so it says, וכשמתגייר גר אחד, and when a convert converts, פורחת נשמה מהיכל ההוא, this soul comes out from this chamber, ונכנסת תחת כנפי השכינה. And it goes from under the wings of the שכינה, והשכינה נושקת אותה, and the שכינה, the female aspect, kisses the soul, משום שהיא תולדה של נשמות הצדיקים, because it is the result of the souls of the righteous people, ושלחת אותה לתוך אותו הגר, and she sends it to this convert, ושוכנת בו, and it's resting within her, within the convert, ומזמן ההוא, הוא נקרא גר צדק. And that's why it's called a just convert. בינו הסוד שכתוב פרי צדיק עץ חיים, the fruit of a righteous person is the עץ חיים, is the tree of life. מה עץ החיים? What is the tree of life? שהוא זרנפין, which is זרנפין, the male aspect of God, מוציא נשמות, which is making the נשמות, which is the צדיקים, the righteous people. אף הצדיק, just like the righteous person, כך הוא הפרי שלו, is the fruit of this עץ החיים, שעושה נשמות that create souls. So that's what I wanted to mention about Zohar Shlach Lecha, where it talks about the women. It's very interesting, describes the Gan Eden. So that's what I wanted to mention from the Zohar. I think we're going to take, or actually we already took a break. I think we're going to start singing now. You guys want to come out? We're going to sing some songs. So we can keep you awake. We're going to sing you some songs. At home, if you guys want to talk with yourselves, whoever you're with, whatever you need this year, it's a skula to talk about tonight, whatever you want, right? It's a skula, it's a good thing to do, you could say, to talk about what you want this year. Talk about it with your friend, talk about it with your spouse, talk about it with whoever you want. Say it out loud to someone or write it down and read some Zohar, scan some Zohar. Because it's going to happen, right? Yes, because it's going to happen. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai is, the Lag BaOmer is the time that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai passed away. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai was on the highest level there could be. And because of that, we have the merit to meditate on Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. And because of that, we're able to ask for what we need. So this is the time you want something happening this year. This is the time to ask. Also, come open it. We have a skula. We have a good thing to do on Lag BaOmer. We found out recently. We light 19 candles. So why 19 candles? So there's a rabbi by the name of Rabbi Eliyahu Mani. He was the rabbi of Hebron a long time ago. And on Lag BaOmer, we light 19 candles for 19 separate tzaddikim. And through that, we ask for whatever we want for this year. Okay, now we're going to sing some songs if you guys want to stay on, be awake.
Gam ki elef begreit zama melo
la 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 la
I guess we'll end it here because it's 2:17 a.m. You guys should, or at least we're going to, we're going to talk about how, what we want for this year, like I said before, and talk amongst yourselves, talk with your family, talk with someone you know, what you want this year. It's Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai will help you, and it will happen this year. Read some Zohar, scan a few lines of Zohar even, and your prayers will be answered. So thank you for joining us and have a great Lag BaOmer and have a good Shabbat also.